Stand by three.
You got those monkeys ready? Where's the midget?
Roger on the monkeys.
Prime the boy.
Are you ready? Is the last button working?
Good, all right, here we go. In three, two, one.
What the?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was standing on this wire. My bad.
It's the WBHP Morning Show with Toni and Gary.
I'm Chris Haley with Haley's Flooring and Interiors and Liberty Safes. And we will be giving away a Liberty Tactical Gun Safe, an $1,100 value. Listen for details.
The Toni and Gary SEC Football Pick'em Contest. Find out more online at TonyandGary.com. And listen weekdays 5 to 8 a.m. here on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
And whatever comes our way.
5:04 on the morning show. Wow. Riots in Charlotte. Again, like Baltimore. Looks like a war zone.
When I went to bed last night, there was confusion, as to whether or not someone was killed.
Someone was shot and is on life support.
Okay, so he did not die. So the initial report was he was killed. And then about the time I went to bed last night, I saw a report that says, well, actually, he's not dead yet.
Yeah. So. But that was a civilian-on-civilian shooting. That was rioter
protesters
on rioter.
That's right.
Somebody in one of the protesters shot another protester. You're right.
I assume it's black on black.
It is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like Chicago up in North Carolina,
I guess
all of a sudden.
Somebody decided they'd take the opportunity to... maybe revenge somebody or gang members or whatever, but it wasn't police.
Well, and you made the perfect point. All of them are taking the opportunity to do things that's not going to help the cause. Mm. Not that there's really even a cause there.
I'm not sure about the cause. We'll get into that in a minute. But,
I mean, looting Walmart and...
You know, stealing big screen TVs and phones and iPads. I mean, how does that further
that the... That may make you feel better. But it doesn't further stated cause.
Yeah, I don't think those are protesters.
Well, no, they're thieves.
They're criminals who take advantage of a situation and
right.
go loot.
That's exactly right.
So
because they don't get in trouble for it.
No.
I don't know how that is.
There's no consequences.
I very often see people who stole, you know, a pack of gum, ran out of Walmart by the cops. And here we are, got 55-inch big screen TVs being carried out.
Yeah, nobody does anything
about
it.
Nobody cares.
Okay, so we're going to talk about football. We'll talk about that. We have a lot to talk about. And we'll get
to all
of it, yes, as usual. Debates coming up on Monday.
Yeah.
New polls out show Trump ahead in a lot of the swing states now.
I saw yesterday, and I didn't think I'd forget where I saw it, but I have. It was on Facebook from someone. But I do know where I saw it. It was Alan West posted it on his blog and in turn shared it on his Facebook page. Apparently, someone who's close to Ms. Clinton said that she may be trying to figure out how to get out of the debate on Monday.
That there were several stories on that yesterday.
I don't know.
But I'm thinking that's probably a conservative dream right there. Because that would be the end of it.
Well, yeah, that I would assume.
If she doesn't show up for the debate, that would be it.
Mm-hmm. But I can see her folks trying to figure out some way to legitimately sit this one out.
I don't know why, because she had good debates with Bernie Sanders.
Because she is sick, Ms.
Well,
Lowry.
She is sick.
Something's wrong with her.
She's sicker than she was.
And she's getting worse.
Yeah, she's getting worse.
I mean, she had to take off again yesterday.
Well, she had a rally yesterday.
Oh, she did go to the rally. Mm-hmm. Or was that the day before she took off?
It was the day before she took off.
Okay.
So.
Now,
supposedly from here forward through Monday, she's doing debate prep again.
So, yeah, which.
Again.
As a matter of fact, Trump posted. I thought it was yesterday, but maybe it was from the day before. It doesn't matter. So, matter of fact, he posted about her taking the day off again. He posted whatever he posted, and then at the end, He said, sleep well.
Yeah, it was the day before. Because yesterday she was in Florida.
So have you also seen the video of some strange eye movement at the rally before she took the day off?
Yeah, and then,
I think that's been blown out of proportion, honestly.
Yeah.
Because I didn't
catch that in real time.
I mean, I make weird faces sometimes. Sure. And I'm not stroking out.
And did they slow-mo it? You know, when you get a still shot of something,
it was, yeah, the one I saw was in slow-mo. And I did go and look at real time because I wanted to see. Because the slow-mo does
make you look weird.
But when you slow things down, a lot of things look weird. You know?
Yes.
So I went to find that, and I was like, well, I mean, it's Hillary Clinton. She looks weird. But I don't think she's got any eye issue, at least at that point. But something's wrong with her, and she's getting worse, and she's having to take off a lot.
Well, she'll take off a lot, and then at the debate, I think we mentioned this the other day, what I believe will happen is they'll pump her up with something.
Yeah, they'll fill her full of formaldehyde or whatever they're putting in her.
To make sure she has to do is get through 90 minutes.
Yeah, that's all.
You know, so.
Isn't that horrible?
It is.
Here we are. If she can just make it through 90 minutes,
and and all he has to do is not, and we talked about this, is not blow up.
Right. Yeah.
Don't lose your cool.
Let her bury herself.
And when they ask you certain questions, then, and don't, I mean, you can take off on the media, but do not bully her.
Yeah.
Don't bully her. Come back. You can have your comeback.
He's got to be strong, though.
He can come back strong without being a bully.
Yeah.
You know?
Well.
He can.
Theoretically.
But
I don't know whether he can or not. But,
well.
But some folks can. Just not sure about Trump. Although he's done very well.
He has.
I'm impressed over the last three weeks.
He's not going to have a prompter.
It's not been only prompter, though. You keep saying that, but it has not been only prompter. He's been on late night shows, and he's done very well. He's been on Fox News without a prompter, done very well. It's not just prompter.
Yeah, but he's not asked specific questions on policy, on those things, really. When you think about it.
Well, not on late night, for sure.
For sure, yeah.
Can you believe that Jimmy Fallon now is being raked over the coals, just like Matt Lauer was? Matt Lauer dared to be fair during his little town hall. Jimmy Fallon did not excoriate Donald Trump.
Mm-hmm. Like the left wanted him to.
And now the left is all over Jimmy Fallon.
Mm-hmm.
And Fallon came out and said, and he's right, because I watch a pretty good bit of Jimmy Fallon because he's funny. Now, he is liberal.
Right.
But he doesn't let a whole lot of that seep through his stuff. He really doesn't. So he tweeted or Facebooked the other day. He said, listen, I'm not hard on any of my guests. Donald Trump or whoever.
Right.
So...
Well,
if the media doesn't do what the liberals want them to do, then they
jump all over them.
Yeah.
So I was reading something. I was trying to find it, but my computer is frozen now. That I thought, if true, was pretty interesting. If true. By the way, it is big prize giveaway Thursday. Get those calls in early. If true, interesting. And it was about the debate moderators. Mm-hmm. And what it said, and I don't have a story right here, I'm going to have to pull it up again, but what it said was that it may not be what you think.
What do you mean?
Well, what it said was that Lester Holt was a registered Republican.
Oh.
It said that Chris Wallace was a registered Democrat.
Hmm.
Now I'm going to have to find the story again.
So it's right the opposite of what we assumed.
What we think.
Yeah.
Well, now that that's put out there, if it is true,
well,
then the media will Lester Holt now feel that he has to be harder on Trump. It's going to be interesting because it's all these little sideshows going on, you know. So,
so I was just looking up to see about Lester Holt being a Republican. Mm-hmm. There are several stories
about him being a Republican.
Wow.
Yeah.
Huh. Well, now listen, I've always told you from the time he took over for the liar in chief, mm-hmm. what's his face, Brian Williams,
mm-hmm.
I like Lester Holt a lot. And I've never seen Now, not that I've seen everything he's ever done in his right. career, in his career, but I've never seen him be biased. But
well,
I guess we'll see.
We'll see. He may feel pressure now.
Well,
now that all these stories are out there.
I'm hoping he's got a little more integrity than that.
Well,
that's kind of what I've always felt about him. But
I know.
Who knows? I don't know.
At this point, who knows?
So this story is from NPR, and they're talking about how Donald Trump was on Bill O'Reilly. And they were talking about the fact that Lester Holt was going to be the moderator.
Mm-hmm.
And Trump, of course, said, well, you know, Lester Holt's a Democrat.
Right. And that's where that came from. Yeah.
And apparently not.
Apparently not.
I mean, according to some folks. Hmm.
I have not seen the actual ID, you know, the actual report. I mean, the paperwork that would show he was a Republican.
Well, I have it right here. It says there's a screenshot from the New York State Voter Registration Service, whatever that's called. Mm-hmm. I guess the Board of Registrars, maybe. Anyway, it says, in fact, a Time Magazine story, and there's a screenshot, points out that Holt has been a registered Republican in the state of New York since 2003.
Wow.
Well,
I
don't know how he even scored the position he's got if he's a registered Republican.
I
wonder if NBC knew that.
Before they hired
beforehand.
Him?
Beforehand. Yeah, there it is. Lester Holt, active political party, Republican. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. All right. Well, that
now,
throws a
now,
monkey.
Now,
or,
look up
yeah,
Chris
the,
Wallace.
Okay.
Well, get that first, and then
look up Chris Wallace.
Democrat. Now, the story I read said something that he had switched to Democrat so he could vote in the local elections in D.C. or something like that, but I'm not mm-hmm. sure.
Okay. Well, I'm going to have to look a little closer on that one.
Yeah. All right.
That one's not as readily available as Lester.
Let's get to the phone, talk to Rose. Hey, Rose, how are you?
I was calling to enter into the daily contest today.
Yeah, Rose, well, you are in there, okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
All right, bye-bye. Sweetie, you have a great day. And T, hey, T, how are you?
Hey, Miss Toni, how are you?
Good.
I'm doing pretty good. I got in bed about 3:30. I watched all the stuff. It's all that bad stuff going on up in North Carolina.
Oh,
it's terrible.
Awful.
But, they had a policeman on there from Nashville. He's a retired policeman, been out of it 10 years, and he said that they got to anybody with been in police work at all one day will know the difference between a book and a pistol.
Yeah.
You know, instead of a book. But it is ridiculous. They're going to have to get that stopped somehow. But as far as Trump, he's come up the ladder quite a bit.
Yes.
I like coach and everything. I'm looking forward to listening to the debate coming up Monday and all. But I don't get qualified for all the big prizes until you enjoy the show. I've been listening to you every morning. It was real. That one yesterday. You know, there's some good stuff on there yesterday. But you had a couple of tributes. I know you ain't got one idea, but you had two on there yesterday that you didn't get answered. I want to answer today, I think. One of them was the double S's.
Yes.
One of them was Skyscraper.
It was Skyscraper. Great memory there.
Yeah, another one there was the Greens. Yeah, I knew four or five of them. Well, one of them was the Green Bay Packers.
That was the Wisconsin team. I love the Green Bay Packers.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, I just want to tell you, enjoy your show, and y'all keep up the good work, and y'all you up to date on all that stuff. And I watch a lot of TV myself in the last year or so, and I think Trump's going to be the man. But Miss Clinton, she does. I watched her. She's down there in Florida yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
I believe. She's going to put a stop to all the rioting and stuff, but she's done way too late, I think, to get it stopped.
Well, I'm surprised that the president hasn't come out, or Loretta Lynch, or somebody saying, you know,
yeah.
stop it.
Yeah.
But it's Baltimore all over again.
Well, Hillary Clinton said she was going to stop all this by talking directly to white people.
Well, that's what T said. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't hear what you said, T.
Mayor of Chicago, he's they think to hire 1,000 more policemen or something, I believe, and all that stuff.
Rahm Emanuel.
Need more cops.
More cops and all that. And then
that you won't allow to do their job.
Mm-hmm.
Run up all that money that Mr. Obama's sent Iran over there $1.3 billion for 10 years. That's $38 billion here for the next 10 years. And they sent them $1.3 billion, I believe they say it is.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it's just...
It's
just
crazy.
Terrible, crazy.
Yeah, supposedly we're going to be sending them money all the time now, I guess.
I hadn't heard that. I was confused there for a moment.
It was some kind of weird deal going on. I haven't had a chance to really research the whole thing.
But Valerie Jarrett is somebody, isn't she?
Isn't she, though? All right, T, we got to go. You have a great day, okay?
Well, have a good day. I'm going to give you a roll tide.
Roll tide.
I'm going to get real early Monday, Saturday, play at 11 o'clock.
So yeah, we got an early game.
Watching football all day. Say, we got a good game on tonight. Georgia State and Clemson plays tonight.
That ought to be a good game.
Yeah, y'all have a good day and keep up the good work and hope you draw my name out of here. I'll see y'all
Thank
later.
You
bye-bye.
Roll tide, T. Jalita. Hey, Jalita, how are you?
I'm fine. Good morning. I wanted to be entered in today's drawing.
Yeah, well, you were in there. And did Jalita win something this week?
Yeah, she's first place winner of our football contest.
Didn't she win $100 in cash?
She did.
Hey, Jalita, where are we going?
Thanks. Nowhere in particular.
What are we going to do with our $100?
I'm going to go shopping.
There you go. That's a perfect thing to do, Jalita. Go shopping.
Thank you.
You have a great day, okay?
So, Chris Wallace.
Yes.
When asked about this by the Political Insider, explained his party affiliation in terms of pragmatism, insisting that being a Democrat is the only feasible means of participating in the political process in heavily Democratic Washington, D.C., and he maintained that he had voted for candidates from both major parties in the past.
Uh-huh.
So he's a registered Democrat.
He is. And Lester Holt, a registered Republican.
That is correct.
Now, I'm just, who would have thunk it?
Do,
it's exactly, we are in the Twilight Zone. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. Everybody hang tight.
Miss Toni and Gary? Listen to our podcast, free, anytime, day or night.
And check out our blog at TonyandGary.com with links to the podcast, email, iHeartRadio, listen online, and all the latest stories and video.
And like us on Facebook. Go to Facebook.com/TonyandGary.
It's the Morning Show with Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
From the Fox Sports Studios in Los Angeles, here's Eddie Garcia.
In baseball, checking games involving teams in the playoff race in the American League, the Red Sox beat the Orioles 5-1. Boston's Andrew Benintendi hit a three-run homer to help the Red Sox win their seventh straight. Their magic number to wrap up the AL East title is now down to 6. 12 innings for the Mariners to walk off with a 2-1 win over the Blue Jays thanks to a Robinson Cano sacrifice fly. Seattle's now just a game and a half back of Baltimore for a wild card spot. The Astros get a couple of Evan Gattis home runs to edge the A's 6-5. Houston is just one game back of Baltimore for the final wildcard spot in the American League. Tigers and Twins were rained out, so Detroit actually gained a half game on Baltimore. They're also one back of a wildcard spot. Yankees beat the Rays 11-5. New York's Gary Sanchez hit 2 home runs, drove in 5. New York's 2.5 back of a wildcard spot in the American League. And the Indians edge the Royals 4-3. Cleveland's magic number to win the AL Central is down to 5 games.
The Lyosi Group has been taking care of your office needs for over 40 years. They've also been saving 95% of their customers money and improving efficiency. In this economy, people don't want to think about buying office equipment, but the Lyosi Group is reducing hard dollar cost for their customers. How? The machines do more and cost less. Lexmark copiers revolutionize how copies, prints, scans, and faxes are made. Don't be afraid to check into saving your company money. The Lyosi Group is where you'll receive quality service guaranteed, response time guaranteed. That means guaranteed satisfaction. Call the Lyosi Group to start reducing your office costs today.
Service, extraordinary service.
Just ask anyone.
650-4150.
The Lyosi Group.
L-I-O-C-E.
This is Michael Berry. Join me this afternoon at 5. Now back to Toni and Gary on the Valley's Big Talker, 800 and 1230 WBHP.
It is a twilight zone out there. I'll tell you what.
When Lester Holt's a Republican and
Chris Wallace,
I assume Chris Wallace was a Democrat, quite honestly.
Well, but
from our last debate performance.
Yes, but we didn't know for sure.
And well, I'm going to look up and see what Megyn Kelly is.
I was just about to say that. Would you look up and see what Megyn Kelly is?
Since you can now Google what party affiliation people are.
Oh, I know. But you can't always believe that, but we're checking. Anyway, kind of interesting. We'll go over the polls. We'll give you an update on what's happening in North Carolina. They're voting right now, by the way. But downtown Charlotte looks like a war
voting.
Zone.
You mean early voting?
Early voting, yes. Mm. All right, let's go to Al. Hey, Al, how are you?
Hey, good morning. I guess it's probably, maybe it's apropos that Corey played the Twilight Zone music because, well, in my head, I mean, it's a tinfoil hat stuff, but this, I swear, this Black Lives Matter ought to be, I mean, to me, they ought to be considered a terrorist organization, but that's not the tinfoil hat part. The tinfoil hat part is, if you start linking all this stuff, I mean, the turmoil in North Carolina associated with HB2 and a critical election for governor there and the national, certainly the North Carolina's role in the national election and these quote-unquote violent protests, which I think Fox News finally called riots, and I was glad to see, but
somebody
probably everybody
riot,
else
yeah.
still calling a violent protest. It takes on, and I mean, I attended Marine Corps Command and graduated from Marine Corps Command and Staff College, and when I started kind of mapping all this out, you know, on paper, this looks like a campaign. I mean, this looks like a military campaign tied to a political campaign, which, of course, is, I mean, read your CrossFits. That's there's a connection there, you know. War is an extension of policy, policy by another means. But again, it almost seems kind of tinfoil hatty. But it's almost like there's an evil entity or something. And I guess the word Soros comes to mind that has an interest in all these things linking together.
Well, the chaos.
And I'm probably not the first person to draw that. But.
Yeah, the chaos of it all. You know, I don't think that they say, okay, let's get somebody to shoot somebody and then we'll do this. I think what they do, and if I'm not mistaken, I think that's the Saul Alinsky playbook,
yes.
is you take a situation that's happening and then you make it,
yeah.
make it yours and you move it into the direction you want it to go in.
Yeah.
I mean, basically.
I mean, chaos is I mean, the evil, the disruption
right.
associated with chaos, his rules for radicals.
Right.
Again, I don't think Soros is directly involved in the but he's funding, last I heard, he was funding some Black Lives Matter type activities and maybe Black Lives Matter itself.
Well, he
it was Black
it
Lives,
was
Lives,
Black
Matter,
Lives
itself.
Matter, yeah, itself. And he has offices, the Black Lives Matter, the I forgot that one guy's name, starts with a D, but, you know, he is now at a university, the black head of the Black Lives Matter chapter. I mean, he was one of the instigators of all of these different things, the pigs in the blanket, the whole thing.
As a matter of fact.
And he's now getting $160,000 a year as a teacher.
George Soros.
Bill Ayers, you mean?
No.
No,
this is a
new one. This
is a Black Lives Matter guy.
So, okay, go ahead. I'm sorry.
So George Soros, you know, kind of like Clinton and Obama created ISIS, George Soros really kind of created Black Lives Matter because, you know, Black Lives Matter was born out of Ferguson, basically.
Right. And he funded
all of those protests.
Yes. And he's funding refugees, you know, getting refugees into America. So I think he put in, what, half a billion dollars here recently. So.
And is he also funding some of the EU refugees?
He is.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I've heard he's kind of globalist, and he's pushing for, and it wouldn't surprise me if he's not pushing for it with money. I mean, he's Hungarian. I guess he's American now, but his roots are in Hungary.
Yeah, he has dual citizenship.
So is he trying to, and I guess he's being successful, but he's getting a lot of the chaos spread in through Europe. But, I mean, the Saul Alinsky connection, it's insidious as heck.
Yeah.
Because Hillary Clinton, and there have been some letters where she basically a fawning letter, but she's met the guy.
Right.
And and who knows, you know, how deep that connection ran, but I guess it was pre-Bill. And she probably got Bill plugged in, but Bill Ayers was plugged into Saul Alinsky. You know, his wife went to prison for, and I guess should probably still be in prison now because she was directly or indirectly involved in the death of some police officers.
Bernadine Dorn, yeah.
Obama, mm-hmm. Yeah, and Obama started his political career in their living room,
mm-hmm.
although he claimed he kind of met them. You know, he backed away from that a little bit.
Right, he didn't know who they were, yeah, blah, 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 blah. But now she's teaching. Bill Ayers, a domestic terrorist, is teaching at a college.
Yeah, because Bill Ayers was involved in the Pentagon bombing.
That's right.
Of all things. And yet they have this level of respectability, like you said. They're teaching, mm-hmm. and colleges, it's just, it blows your mind.
It does.
When I was watching, I was watching the live Fox feed last night until I went to sleep, but the Fox feed from Charlotte, and these chants, this behavior, I mean, it takes on asymmetrical, which is another way of saying guerrilla warfare, but it takes on the same kind of, I mean, because it's like the live feed from Ferguson.
It is.
You know,
exactly.
In other words,
the same.
These people are saying the same kind of thing. And it's for all the world, like, and I know some of this is coming out of Oakland, the Black Panthers, and those kind of folks. And again, there's affiliation there, directly and indirectly, with Black Lives Matter. But they were sent out, and it's almost like they sent early leaders in, and I use the word leader, you know, advisedly. But I mean, they sent early leaders in to kind of coordinate. I mean, Baltimore, same kind of thing,
mm-hmm.
you know. Rocks that weren't indigenous to a certain area just suddenly showed up.
Right.
You know, these people have it all planned, including the logistics of the food and what we call the Marine Corps, beans, bullets, band-aids, and bad guys. You know, I mean, they how to take care of, I mean, it's for all the world like a military campaign.
It is.
And we're not seeing it that way.
Al, we got to go.
Hey, Al, real yeah. quick, I want to say, if you want to be entertained, go to YouTube
yeah.
later today at after 8 a.m. and type in yeah. Bill Ayers, Dinesh D'Souza debate. They made like a national tour last year and parts
yeah.
of this year where they went to these different places and they had debates with each other.
One-on-one.
And they are good.
Yeah.
And they're not, they're the Lincoln Douglas type debates.
Right.
They just kind of chit-chat and...
Right.
Ask each other questions. They get fiery. They're good.
I like those kind of debates. I'd like mm-hmm. to see that Monday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hillary.
Okay, I'll do that, Cor.
Hillary and Trump just sitting there talking back and forth. Wouldn't that be something?
Hillary wouldn't stand a chance. I'm telling you, she's going to have the questions in advance. All right. Bye, y'all.
Bye, Al. Got to go. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Listen to Toni and Gary on your smartphone.
Download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2. And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Toni and Gary.
It's the morning show with Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Keeping you informed. Now, a Tennessee Valley news update on WBHP.
Good morning, I'm Michelle Stark. Here's an update from the WHNT News 19 newsroom. A civilian was shot Wednesday during a second night of violent protests in Charlotte, North Carolina. It follows a fatal police shooting of a black man, Keith Lamont Scott. North Carolina's governor declared a state of emergency overnight as well. A U.S. official tells CBS News the wife of the suspect in the New York and New Jersey bombings is now headed to the U.S. Ahmad Khan Rahami's wife, Asia Bibi Rahami, is returning voluntarily. According to CBS News, she is not believed to be a suspect. Bluebell Creameries recalled select flavors of ice cream distributed across the South after finding chocolate chip cookie dough from a third-party supplier for use as an ingredient was possibly contaminated with listeria. Bluebell says it's recalling half gallons and pints of Bluebell chocolate chip cookie dough and half gallons of Bluebell cookie two-step made at its Sylacauga, Alabama creamery. I'm Michelle Stark, and those are some of the top stories on this Thursday.
We have a great new show on WBHP, Huntsville's Big Talker, you don't want to miss. It's The Land Show with Dave Milton. Dave informs you on everything you need to know about investing in land. Be sure to tune in Saturday mornings from 9 a.m. till 10 a.m. for The Land Show with Dave Milton. And visit thelandshow.com to get Dave's free report, 7 Proven Land Investment Strategies. Don't miss The Land Show with Dave Milton for successful land investing every Saturday morning, 9 till 10, right here on WBHP, Huntsville's Big Talker.
It lets you listen to the best live radio stations in the country. It lets you create custom music stations with over 20 million songs. It lets you listen to thousands of podcasts. But its most amazing feature is that it's free. Yeah, I said free. Our iHeartRadio app. All your favorite music. All your favorite stations. All free. Free. Use our iHeartRadio app today or listen online at iHeartRadio.com.
This is the sound of a brand new outdoor grill being hurled off a 20-story building. Now a stylish glass coffee table. An electric guitar. These are the things you could enjoy all cast into oblivion. Because when you throw away money on wasted electricity, you throw away everything you could have bought with it. Visit EnergySavers.gov and get tips on how to save energy and money. Then do things like switch to Energy Star light bulbs or Energy Star appliances, and you could save hundreds of dollars a year. So this doesn't happen to the recliner you've had your eye on, or this to the treadmill on your wish list, or this to the shiny new bike your kid's been asking for. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at EnergySavers.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Energy and the Ad Council.
Your morning, your show, Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP. The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation.
Thursday morning traffic looking good around the valley. We're not spotting any problems around Athens, around Decatur. No problems around Madison. Things are moving okay coming out of Harvest on Highway 53. No problems on 565 or along the Parkway. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
Someone you know is suffering from Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. They're dealing with excruciating pain and days when they won't be able to get out of bed. Help someone you know and support the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation of America at ccfa.org.
It's about your life and your money. It's the Dave Ramsey Show.
Self-discipline. It's one of the most powerful things that a human being can learn. Parents who do not teach their children discipline do not set them up for the ability to learn to discipline themselves or control themselves, because you are not teaching your child self-control. Consequently, we've raised a wussified generation. The Dave Ramsey Show, weekdays at 11 on WBHP.
The Train Comfort Specialist. He's so reliable that buses set their schedules to him. Once, he was the best man for a guy he didn't even know. He's never used a snooze button. The Unstoppable Train Comfort Specialist. Just one more reason why it's hard to stop a train.
And now, with new technology to combat bacteria, viruses, and allergens, will be even harder to stop. I'm Bo Thomas, and I am your Train Comfort Specialist. Call Thomas HVAC today, 256-858-4822, or go to coolhuntsville.com.
Speed limit 55. Right turn only. Exit here. With some signs, it's clear what you're supposed to do. But heart attack warning signs aren't always this obvious. They can feel like arm pain, nausea, dizziness, shortness of breath, fatigue. If you experience the warning signs, call 911 and know that you can count on the accredited chest pain center at Crestwood Medical Center for nationally recognized heart care.
Locally family-owned and operated for over 46 years, Bankston Motorhomes is your go-to place when looking for an RV. From travel trailers to fifth wheels to motorhomes, we've got it all. With locations in Huntsville on Jordan Lane, Albertville, Alabama, Florence, Alabama, Nashville, Tennessee, and Ardmore, Tennessee, we are sure to have a location near you. Stop on by or browse our inventory online at BankstonMotorhomes.com.
Toni and Gary sound better in HD. Listen on your HD radio at 102.1 HD2.
Hey, this is Bo Thomas with Thomas HVAC Company. It's football season. That means I'll be giving away $100 in cash to one Toni and Gary listener each week.
The Toni and Gary SEC Football Pick'em Contest. Find out more online at TonyandGary.com and listen weekdays 5 to 8 a.m. here on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Welcome back to the morning show. Okay, what are we giving away?
$40 for Popeye's Cajun Fried Chicken. Movie passes for two at Hollywood 18. Family four-pack to the Botanical Gardens. $20 from Dunkin' Donuts, Huntsville and Madison. And today is Big Prize Giveaway Thursday, so we've added $100 to Nick's Ristorante on South Bailey Cove in Huntsville.
And a day pass to the range at Last Resort Guns, County Line Road in Madison.
All you have to do is call us. At the end of the show, we'll draw from all the people who have called in. And that person wins.
534-3521 and 309-2313.
538 on the morning show. We have added prizes. We have added golfer two at Point Mallard's championship course and a family four-pack to Tate Farms, which opens in a couple of weeks. So, all that, plus Nick's and everything else, is going to one person today. Corey is doing his amazing stuff in there with our podcast, so...
Yeah, we've got some new stuff
going. We may have
going.
Some new information going.
Those of you who couldn't download directly to your computer, you can now. Just go back and click... I haven't told you that yet, Ms. Lowry. If you go to our blog, TonyGary.com, over on the right, you'll see, listen to whatever I've got put there. Did you miss the show today? Click here to listen. That's what it says. When you click there to listen, you're going to be taken to, number one, a YouTube version of our show, if that's what you want to do. And number two, it says download the show. Click here. You click there, and it just downloads
now,
for you.
All the shows are there, right? From the past?
No.
Okay.
I can't get the shows from the past there, no.
None of them, not YouTube, but the other one.
That's right. No.
So what page did they go to listen to those from last week? We need to have that on there, too.
Yeah. Well, I can do that.
Because those are on the other page.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. So we need to have a menu.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, because a lot of people wanted to listen to those from last week.
Sure.
Well, yeah.
Those cannot be downloaded at the moment.
Well, they can't be downloaded, but they can still listen to them.
Yes, they can.
Yeah, so we'll fix that. All right, so let's play.
We won't, but I will.
But Corey will fix that. That's right.
I love it when you say we.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what game are we playing? BR. Two words. First
549.
Word, first word begins with B.
Mm-hmm.
Second word begins with R. Okay. His 714 career home runs was the most before Hank Aaron.
Mm-hmm.
Or, candy bar made of peanuts, caramel, chocolate-flavored nougat, covered in compound chocolate. Really? Compound chocolate?
Starts with what?
B-R. All answers, one word. First word is B, as in boy.
Mm-hmm.
Second word, R, is in run.
Huh. Okay.
Okay. Next.
There's a food question I don't know the answer to.
Imagine I'm surprised. That. Money.
Oh, owed. I do know that one. Never mind.
I was going to say, I'm very surprised.
It took me a minute.
Money owed by a lessee for already having inhabited a dwelling. Money owed by a lessee for already having inhabited a dwelling. B-R.
Huh.
Okay.
All right.
An NFL team. Remember, two words. First word B, second word R. An NFL team.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Clyde Barrow, Bonnie Parker, and Willie Sutton. Clyde Barrow, Bonnie Parker, and Willie Sutton. B R.
That's the clue.
Mm-hmm. a rodeo event. B R.
Mm-hmm.
This ice cream company known for 31 flavors. I bet you know that one.
I do know that one, yes. Tried all 31 of them.
A prime cut of bovine meat. A
a prime cut of bovine meat, BR. One more. Quasimodo. Quasimodo, BR. All right, phone numbers are
256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
Let's go to Jim. Hey, Jim, how are you?
Hey, good morning. How's it going?
Good. How are you doing?
Good, good. I got several of these answers.
I just need one.
Oh, okay.
Try one of the hard ones.
Try one of the hard ones?
Yeah.
Back rent.
What is it?
Back rent.
Back rent is what it is. That is right. Money owed a lessee for already having inhabited a dwelling would be back rent.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good job, Jim.
Yeah. Yeah, and the one, I won't say it, but the NFL one that I'm still thinking about it, but I can't, maybe somebody will get it. I immediately thought about the baseball team.
Yeah.
ER.
Mm-hmm. You can say that one. I don't have that on here.
Not. I can say that one?
Yeah, because I don't have that.
Okay, that would be the Boston Red Sox.
Boston Red Sox, that's right. But I'm looking for the football team, but
I guess it's probably because that's three words. Boston Red Sox, right? Is that probably why it's not on this on this quiz?
Maybe. Mm-hmm. Maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's curious, I thought about the meat one, but I'm thinking I probably got the wrong answer for the meat one.
Mm.
And I won't say it.
Good.
You better move on.
Move on. Yeah.
Hey, you know, everybody, you were talking the other day about, you know, how every time you mention the word racial profiling, you have to clarify it and say, we are not racially profiling for Muslims. We're racially profiling for, you know, something else.
It's behavioral profiling, not racial profiling.
Yeah.
Behavioral profiling.
Why don't we eliminate the word profiling? Because that seems to bother everybody. And to say behavioral analysis.
Well, that's true. Like that. That's very true, because it's the profiling part that gets the media and everybody all up in arms.
Yeah, but once you change a word, but it basically means the same thing, it doesn't matter. Because the media will then turn that word into a dirty word.
Well, even Kellyanne Conway, who was on with whatever her name is on CNN at 6 o'clock, I forgot her name, but she told her, she said, you know, I don't know why you put racial in front of that profiling, because Trump never said that. And the girl said, well, no, you're right. He didn't say that. It's just we know what he meant. And
really?
It's like, what?
Wow.
No, they know what they're trying to label him as.
Yes, a racist.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's so bad.
It is.
Well, anyway, I think he's going to continue to get beat down by everybody except, you know, Fox News, because they're all in the tank for Hillary.
They are.
I just never understand why. You know, she's there was some more stuff came out yesterday about her body double. And,
body double.
Yeah.
I am not getting on board with this body double thing yet.
I know.
You did hear me say yet, right? I'd have to see a lot more.
Oh, I'm sure she's used the body double for some reasons. I don't know that it's been during this campaign, but you know that's been used by Hillary Clinton.
Well, the key would be to watch your Secret Service detail to see if there's different people with her.
You mentioned that before. You actually mentioned, when we first started talking about this body double, that Secret Service was conspicuously absent when Hillary Clinton or whomever emerged from Chelsea's apartment.
Right.
On 9/11.
Well, I thought it was interesting yesterday. Good
grief. You need me to come in there and kick it?
Yes. You know, I'm about ready to buy my own computer in here.
Yeah, it didn't go over well with.
No, they don't. They don't want to fix it, but they don't want to let you buy your own. So she had an interview in Tampa, Florida yesterday, and she had an interview in Florida yesterday.
Hillary,
and she was asked whether or not she would take any neurocognitive tests before November.
Somebody asked her that.
Mm-hmm.
Are they still alive?
Yes, and she said, she laughed it off and said, well, you know, I don't need that, right? You know. But it was about a 12-minute long interview.
Well, if you don't need it, then you don't have a problem taking it, right?
And,
you know, the test, I mean.
Well, and you know, for her, when they asked her about her health and for her to say that, she said, you know, I'm very sorry that I got pneumonia. I'm very glad that antibiotics took care of it, mm-hmm. and that's behind us now. I've met the standard that everybody running for president has met in terms of releasing information about my health. I have to say my opponent has not met that standard.
What?
Well, what she's saying is she released 2 pages.
And he only released one?
And he only released one, yeah.
Really?
John McCain released 1,200.
Well, he had a few more things
to
talk about.
He had a few more things to talk about. So I am very happy that we have put out all the information that there is that reflects on my health, and I'm physically, mentally healthy and fit to be president of the United States.
If I were Kellyanne Conway, I would take the one-page thing that Trump released, and I would go and double the font and re-release
into two pages.
That's exactly what
I'd do. So the reporter said, would you be willing to take those tests now, talking about the neurocognitive tests?
Right.
And she said, there's no need for that. I mean,
no.
The information is very clear. The information, as I said, meets the standards that every other person running for president has ever had to meet. And I'm happy that we've met and it even exceeded them in certain ways.
Who is this person that asked her this question? A 12-year-old?
Yeah.
Adults don't have the backbone to do it, do they?
No. Anyway, so...
You don't know who asked her the question, do you?
So, well, I'm trying to... Yeah, I have her name here, okay. Actually. Her,
but we won't know her.
You won't know who she is. She's a local TV reporter.
That's what I was trying to get at.
Oh yeah, it wasn't national. It was local.
Well, that explains it.
Anyway, so then there was a paragraph in the New York Times that was published earlier in the week that said, because Mrs. Clinton and Mr. Trump are in the age range of increased risk for Alzheimer's and mm-hmm. other forms of dementia, some experts have urged they both take neurocognitive tests that can detect early clues to dementia.
Now, that's what Trump ought to take one.
That's yeah. What
he ought to take one.
And then say, okay, Hillary.
And then he can rail against her for not taking one.
Yeah. Anyway. So there we are, Jim.
Yeah, we're going to drive to Missouri today.
You be careful, okay?
Oh, that's right. We're leaving today, aren't we?
Yeah, we're going on a road trip.
Road trip.
Be careful.
Be very careful,
Jim. It's a long drive.
You let us know how it's going, okay?
Well, I'll probably call in tomorrow.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you, Jim.
Okay, bye.
And let's get Greg in here. Hey, Greg, how are you?
Hey, good morning, guys. Thanks for taking my call.
Yeah.
The NFL team named after one of my favorite authors, the Baltimore Ravens.
Baltimore Ravens, that's what it is.
I've actually been to Poe's grave up there in Baltimore. It's a pretty cool trip. I'd like to go do some of the other events. You know, they have the house up there. I think it's closed part of the year, things like that.
You know, a lot of history.
Yeah, you bet. Yeah, Baltimore's a cool city. Go get the crab cake.
Yeah, that's right. As long as they're not rioting, everything's good.
Well, that's true. Yeah, just got to stay in the reasonably safe areas.
Yeah, that's true. But it does have a lot of history there. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Good to talk to you, Greg.
Hey, thanks for taking my call. Good to talk to you guys.
Yeah, don't be a stranger. Got to take a break?
I'm trying not to. Well, and I tried not to be. In fact, yeah, my wife and I made a mix-up about coming down. I got outside the 30-day window, unfortunately.
Oh, you won prizes and didn't pick them up?
Yeah, we had a mix-up between my wife and me. But we appreciate your generosity.
Oh.
Yeah, they're probably...
Okay. It's an honorable mention, right? That's kind of the story of my life.
Oh, I'm sorry, Greg.
No, it's no problem.
All right. You have a great day, okay?
Good talking to you.
We'll take a break. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Miss Toni and Gary? Listen to our podcast free anytime, day or night.
And check out our blog at TonyandGary.com with links to the podcast, email, iHeartRadio, listen online, and all the latest stories and video.
And like us on Facebook.
Go to Facebook.com/Tony and Gary.
It's the Morning Show with Tony and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by Unbound.
We're off to a good start this morning. The weather, not a problem. So far, things are moving fine around Decatur and around Athens. We're not spotting any problems on the interstate, the parkway, or heading over Chapman Mountain on Highway 72. If you see traffic trouble, let us know. We'll pass it along. Our number is 877-811-3367. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
There's a girl in El Salvador who dreams of becoming an engineer. There's an elder in Uganda who dreams of having a community to call his own. No two dreams are the same. Help one person achieve theirs at unbound.org. That's unbound.org.
Say good morning to Keith Pinkerton. He is Mr. Electric. Now, Keith, every month we have severe weather in the Tennessee Valley. Power outages, a big problem. But you can help stop that.
That is correct. We can actually come in and install a whole house generator that automatically senses when the power goes off, takes you off the utility grid, and turns on the generator and powers up your house during a power outage. And when it power comes back on, it senses it and shuts down the generator and puts you back on the utility grid.
And another important feature with Mr. Electric is making sure you're safe at home.
We actually have a home safety inspection, electrical home safety inspection that we do when we come out to your house. And, and we inspect your whole electrical system and we educate you about your electrical system. And if we see any code violations or anything that needs to be addressed, we'll give you a free upfront quote.
Call Mr. Electric today at 1-888-536-8119.
Don't get taken for a ride on the price of your next car or truck. I'm Jerry Reynolds, the Car Pro. Let me help you.
Email Jerry at carprousa.com. Then listen this weekend.
Saturdays noon to 3 and Sundays 9 to 11 a.m. on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Think about how many ways businesses have to deliver their message. A lot, right? Radio, TV, outdoor, not to mention new media like the web, social networks, and mobile. If you're a small business owner, you've probably wondered how to get your message delivered to your customers effectively. Well, we have a workshop that lasts a little more than 30 minutes that can help you put it all together. And we have a team of professionals that will walk you through the process and help you get it done. Would you like to learn more? Listen carefully.
These workshops will be held at the Embassy Suites Hotel in downtown Huntsville this Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, multiple times each day, and there's no charge to attend. In fact, you'll get lunch for two from Walton's Southern Table just for attending. Call today to reserve your spot, 256-309-2400. That number again is 256-309-2400. These workshops will be held at the Embassy Suites Hotel in downtown Huntsville this Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Call today to reserve your spot, 256-309-2400.
I'm Tony Goldwyn. 20 years ago, when my mom had lung cancer, she didn't have many choices. But today, you do. If you've been diagnosed with lung cancer, please visit standuptocancer.org/lungcancer to learn more.
Got a home improvement question? I've got the answers. Join me, Gary Sullivan, this Sunday at 3 here on WBHP.
Hi, this is Janet Kinchelow-Martin with Calhoun Community College, and if you are 60 years old or older, you can take any class at Calhoun Community College tuition-free. You can call us at 306-2500 Indicator, 890-4700 in Huntsville, or at calhoun.edu.
Thank you, Janet. We're going to unpack the whole Charlotte thing, including the discrepancy between what the police chief is saying happened and what the family of the man that was shot said happened. We'll unpack all of that. We'll keep it separate from what happened in Tulsa, because I kind of convoluted those things yesterday. So we'll keep you up to date, and I'm going to give you the latest of what the media is not telling you has happened overnight in Charlotte, including a CNN reporter who was knocked down. It's on video.
Yeah, I saw that.
Did you see that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They said, well, he came back and apologized.
Really?
Yeah.
They said that?
They said that on the air. They said, well, the protester came back and apologized for knocking you down. Anyway.
What hacks?
They are hacks.
Do you believe that? Do you believe that they came back and apologized?
No, I don't. Not for 1 minute.
Me either.
Anyway, Anthony Weiner.
Oh, what a.
Anthony Weiner, it looks like, carried on a months-long online sexual relationship with a 15-year-old girl, according to the Daily Mail.
Yep.
Now, I can't read to you what he said to her.
There's no telling. I didn't even
go that far. I had to actually delete that part out of my email in case somebody saw it. It was so bad. I mean, it was bad.
He's a sicko. He is a sicko. He needs to be in prison.
Well, he may be now. She's 15. If it's true, she's underage, whether you're sexting or not.
We'll see how that goes. I doubt a thing in the world happens.
Hey, Gail, how are you?
Oh, good morning, Toni. I just want you to know I'm here listening, and I really appreciate all of this research you're doing and all these details that you're bringing us. And I enjoy listening to everybody's comments.
Thank you, Gail. We're up against a hard break here. We'll be right back.
The Beatles, live at the Hollywood Bowl. Their only official live album. Remixed, remastered, and now with four bonus tracks. Experience the Beatles phenomenon live. The perfect companion to the Ron Howard film, 8 days a week, The Touring Years.
Streaming exclusively on Hulu. The Beatles, live at the Hollywood Bowl. Available everywhere.
If you thought those primary debates were wild,
first of all, this guy's a joke artist, and this guy's a liar.
You better strap yourself in for this. The first presidential debate. Hillary Clinton.
He is trying to scam America.
And Donald Trump.
She's got a temperament of a loser.
This ain't gonna be no kumbaya love fest. Because honestly, that'd be boring. Listen to it live, Monday night at 8 on 800 and 1230. WBHP.
So why do people drive from all over the Southeast to Eddie Pruitt Ford?
Tremendous savings on new Ford cars and trucks, crossovers, and SUVs.
Right now, great buys at Eddie Pruitt Ford. Great incentives from Ford Motor Company, as well as from Eddie Pruitt himself. And he's got those program vehicles with still under factory warranty mileage on them at Eddie Pruitt Ford, and you can save thousands and thousands of dollars. And at Eddie Pruitt Ford, every new Ford comes with a powertrain lifetime warranty. You heard me right. A lifetime powertrain warranty with every new Ford sold at Eddie Pruitt Ford. So do like I do and have been doing for years. I head over to Hartselle, Alabama, Highway 31 and do business with my friend Eddie Pruitt. And you'll do it too because he'll treat you right at Eddie Pruitt Ford, Highway 31, Hartselle.
This is WBHP Huntsville, WHOS Decatur, and WDRM FM HD2 Decatur, an iHeart radio station.
Fox News Radio, I'm Rich Dennison. A second night of violence in Charlotte, North Carolina, with one person on life support after being shot by someone attending the demonstrations. Several police officers injured. Governor Pat McCrory declaring a state of emergency, sending in the National Guard and state police.
I'm going to do everything I can to protect our city, our state, and especially support our police.
Protests erupting after a black police officer shot a black man who investigators say refused to drop a gun. The city of Chicago planning to hire 500 new police officers in an effort to reduce the growing crime rate there.
So we have the staffing levels we need to execute our crime strategy and protect the people of the city of Chicago.
Chicago Police Superintendent Eddie Johnson. Crews working to restore electricity to Puerto Rico's 3.5 million people after a fire at a power plant blacked out the entire U.S. territory. Officials hope to restore service later this morning. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Car Pro Show. What is it? Here's Kevin McCarthy.
Everything you ever wanted to know about any aspect of the car business or any aspect of any car, but didn't have somebody who would give you straight talk and honest answers?
Nothing confusing about that. Email the Car Pro at carprousa.com and get your questions answered.
I'm Kevin McCarthy.
I'm the Car Pro, Jerry Reynolds.
Saturdays noon to 3 and Sundays 9 to 11 a.m. on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Dick Morris says Trump can defeat Hillary, but he must fight back. In his runaway New York Times bestseller, Armageddon, How Trump Can Defeat Hillary, Morris reveals a winning plan. Morris knew Hillary for 20 years. In Armageddon, he reveals her darkest secrets. Now, Trump must expose these secrets. Newsmax calls Armageddon the most explosive book of the campaign. Armageddon. At bookstores everywhere, or get Newsmax's free offer. Call 800-NEWSMAX, 800-NEWSMAX, or go to Newsmax2016.com.
salesperson. Paid by Open Jar.
Attention. This is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter implanted to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, and even death. If you or a loved one has had an IVC filter implanted, you may be entitled to substantial compensation, even if you haven't experienced any injury at this time. IVC filters have been considered an accident waiting to happen by many. Call the IVC helpline now at 800-216-HURT for a free consultation with an experienced attorney. IVC filters have been known to fracture and cause tearing of the heart, lungs, internal bleeding, and even death. Our network of experienced attorneys are ready to fight for you. You pay no fees unless your case is settled, but time is limited to make a claim. Don't fight this alone. If you or a loved one has an IVC filter implanted, call the IVC helpline now. Operators are standing by 24/7 to take your call at 800-216-HURT. 800-216-HURT. That's 800-216-HURT.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by SOS Children's Villages.
Thursday morning traffic, we're off to a good start. The weather, not a problem. So far, things are moving okay on the parkway. We're not spotting any delays heading over Chapman Mountain. No problems on 565. And so far, it's a good ride around Athens and around Decatur. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
War, poverty, and disaster have left millions of children around the world orphaned, abandoned, alone. When their parents can't be there, SOS Children's Villages is there in 134 countries, including the U.S. To make a difference in a child's life, go to sosusa.org.
You know, if you're buying a home in the Tennessee Valley, you already know how important it is that you have a real estate agent with experience in the area. But did you know it's also important to have experience when you're selling your home? Carrie Rosenblum of Rosenblum Realty tells us why. Carrie?
Gary, it's very true. When you go out to sell a home, it's more than just driving sign up out in front of your yard and waiting on the buyer to walk through the door or your phone to ring. What we'll do is try to give you detailed information to intelligently price your home. It's very important to be in the market and also to have the proper condition and placement of advertising that needs to be done. So we'll educate you on what we will do to help get the right kind of marketing done on your home, to help those days on market to be fewer for you. The longer it stays on the market is not an advantage for a seller, so we will be able to look at the market on a weekly basis, make those adjustments. Call us at Rosenblum Realty, 539-9501, or come to us on the web at rosenblumrealty.com, and we'll help you sell your home.
Gary Rosenblum with Rosenblum Realty.
Gary Dobbs here, talking with Stuart Tanksley, a pro fence of the Tennessee Valley. Stuart, tell us what you do.
We build just about any kind of fence you want within reason, obviously. We try to ensure that our customers get what they pay for, mm-hmm. and they get the best value. I like to sell people on quality instead of price, but there's an old adage that says, you know, you get what you pay for.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's something that we're proud to stand behind. You know, we build a better quality product by taking extra steps and extra measures that we don't charge extra for. And, you know, being a small business versus some of our competitors, we don't have the huge overhead.
And with lower overhead, you can pass that savings along to your customers. So give ProFence a call. Talk to Stuart Tanksley. The number is 584-0092. That's 256-584-0092. If you want a fence built right and you want to save money, you need to be talking to ProFence.
Glenn Beck. Mornings 8 to 11.
I'm telling you, you will laugh.
You will cry.
You will feel.
You'll freak out.
WBHP.
I'm Kerry Rosenblum with Rosenblum Realty, and it's football season again, and that means I'll be giving away $50 cash to one lucky Tony and Gary listener each week.
The Tony and Gary SEC Football Pick'em Contest. Find out more online at tonyandgary.com and listen weekdays 5 to 8 a.m. here on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
On the morning show. All right, you got to get your picks in. Get your picks in. Go to our blog at tonyandgary.com. We have listed the four games that we are playing this week. Kent State at Alabama, Georgia at Ole Miss, Florida at Tennessee, LSU at Auburn. Right under that, it says click here to submit your picks. That's our email. Send us an email. Tell us who you think is going to win by how many points. Put football picks in the subject line. Don't forget to include your name and phone number. That is so important. Have it in by tomorrow night midnight. And then Corey will do his work figure out who came closest. First place, $100 in cash from Bo Thomas, Thomas HVAC. Second place, $50 in cash from Carrie Rosenblum, Rosenblum Realty. And then at the end of the season, we'll put all of the entries into the barrel. And one person will take away the Liberty Tactical Gun Safe from Haley's. You can see a picture of it on our blog at TonyandGary.com. Haley's on Bob Wallace, where you can order your safes for Christmas now.
Something that doesn't happen to me very often, probably has never happened to me, as I'm putting in our picks for the week from our good folks. Auburn's not doing too good, according to our pickers. If Auburn pulls this out, if they beat LSU Saturday, at least according to our pickers, that's going to be a huge upset.
Yes.
Yeah.
We'll see.
So I kind of felt sorry for Auburn yesterday as I was putting that in.
As you were putting all
and that's never happened before.
Because you do that on a daily basis. There's so many.
But if there's any team that I don't like more than Auburn, that would be LSU. So I'm War Eagle.
For this week, yes. I always root for Auburn when they're not playing Alabama.
Yeah, that's why I didn't do so good last week. I picked Auburn. I got to pick Auburn.
Yeah, but the week before you came in third overall.
Right, but Auburn won.
Sure did.
Remember?
Yeah, they did. That's true. Yeah.
I'm going to pick Auburn and Alabama. You know?
Yeah, no matter what. Yeah,
no matter what.
You know, I was thinking about that as I was putting those in yesterday. I thought, you know, if I played this, I don't think, even though if I knew deep down in my heart that Alabama was going to lose. I don't think I could pick against them.
No.
Yeah, that's true. Well. All right, we'll get back to trivia here in a second, but I want to unpack what's going on in North Carolina a little bit. So the family of the man who was shot, says that he was sitting in his car, reading a book, waiting for one of his children to get off the school bus when he was shot. Basically, that's what they say happened.
He was sitting in the car reading a book, and a cop come up and shot him.
And shot him.
All right.
Now.
Well, that sounds horrible.
It does. Sounds awful.
Yeah.
But now let's listen to the police chief of Charlotte, and this is what he said in a press conference.
Yesterday, September 20th, at about 4 o'clock, we had officers from our Metro Division Crime Reduction Unit searching for a suspect who was wanted for outstanding warrants. This occurred at the Village College Downs Apartments. Our officers observed a subject, Mr. Keith Lamont Scott, inside a vehicle at the apartment complex. He exited the vehicle armed with a handgun. The officers observed him get back into that vehicle, at which time they approached the vehicle to engage this subject. The officers gave loud, clear, verbal commands, which were also heard by many of the witnesses. They were instructing the subject, once he got out of the vehicle, to drop the weapon. In spite of the verbal commands, Mr. Scott, as I said, exited his vehicle armed with a handgun as the officers continued to yell at him to drop it. He stepped out, posing a threat to the officers, and Officer Brentley Vinson subsequently fired his weapon, striking the subject. The officers immediately requested medic and began performing CPR. Medic responded and transported the subject to the scene to CMC, where he later was succumbed by his injuries. Our detectives, through their investigation, recovered the firearm that the subject was holding in his hand when he got out of the vehicle. It was in very close proximity to the subject.
All right, so here we have the family saying that Keith Scott was sitting in his car, reading a book, waiting on one of his children to get off the school bus. Police shot him.
Yeah.
Here we have the police chief say his police officers had gone to issue a warrant, not to this guy,
right,
but somebody in the complex, and Keith Scott gets out of his vehicle with a gun.
After being told not to.
Well, he gets out with a gun, and then they tell him to put the gun down and
Right.
Be still. And he gets back in his vehicle with a gun. Then he gets back out again.
Okay, yeah.
So he's not...
complying.
Complying at all. And he's got a gun.
Right.
Now, the officer that shot him is black. The Keith Scott is black.
Hmm.
So it's not a race thing, right? Allegedly.
It wouldn't appear to be.
But they're two totally different stories. Now, the family has come out and said the police planted the gun. That he didn't have a gun. He had a book.
Really?
Was there more on that?
No, that was it.
You sure? Mm-hmm. Because they asked him in that press conference, well, what about the book? He said there was no book. There was no book in the car. There was no book on the ground. Yeah. There was no book. There was a gun.
Right.
Now.
So what if there was a book? He had a gun.
But the police officer.
I got some books in my Jeep, but I don't read them. But the police officer
that shot him did not have a body cam on.
Okay.
So, but they said they do have video. But they haven't released it yet.
Well, I read yesterday that there is a new law, and I'll have to go back and refresh my memory because I've forgotten exactly what the law was about. But there's a new law in North Carolina where they may not be able to release police video. I'll have to go back and read that.
Okay.
But that'll be big if they don't release it.
Yeah, because then it's, he said, she said, whatever.
Well, yeah, I mean, you talk about the conspiracies going
on.
Oh,
absolutely. Or that they're doctoring the video or blah, 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 blah.
So, I'll find that story.
So that's the controversy right now. So the rioting in Charlotte, the protesting, was because they said the police planted a gun, that he didn't have a gun. He was just sitting there waiting for his kid to get off the bus.
Yeah. So who do we believe? So,
I don't know. Who do you
believe? Don't know. Heck, I know who I believe. The police.
So that was a rhetorical question,
that was,
right?
Yeah, I didn't want it. I didn't want that answer.
Now, here's the thing. As usual, you have some protesters, and then the agitators come in, the criminals, and they riot and loot and break windows. So the police were out and gunned. They were outnumbered.
Last night, you mean?
Yes. Mm-hmm. And so they had to bring in the National Guard, which he had done today. The governor declared a state of emergency, and media crews were pulling out. Rioters were blocking highways. In fact, let's go to one of the truck drivers, who was a woman, and listen to what she was telling reporters.
Wasn't it 911?
Or 911.
I'm pretty sure it's 911.
Yeah, that's who it is.
They ordered you out.
They in the trailer. No, they on the back of the trailer as we speak right now.
Now, she went on to say, and this, they were looting her trailer while she was in the cab. This is a truck driver.
Wow.
She's scared for her life. You know, they broke into the back of the trailer. They're looting it. They started fires on the highway to stop the trucks. So not only were they looting the city and burning the city down, trying to, downtown Charlotte, but, you know, they're robbing people, stopping cars. They were throwing rocks off the top of the bridge, hitting vehicles, trying to make them crash. These people ought to be in jail. Fox officially had evacuated all their news crews. I'm reading some of the news reports from last night. As the National Guard en route, SWAT sent out, protests escalating. Protesters now on I-277 setting up cones to block traffic like they did the night before on I-85. It's horrific. Actually, there's video now showing the mob breaking into, I guess, what is a souvenir store. The video shows them pulling the cash register out into the street and breaking it open, and then they mobbed the person that was doing that because there was a bunch of money in there. Mm. Then it says they stole the cash register, stripped it of its contents, only one of many local businesses that were ransacked.
Wow.
Protesters just robbed another store in downtown Charlotte, took all the Hornets gear. Charlotte Hornets, NBA. Ah.
Mm-hmm.
And
stole
all the gear.
The basketball people's gear?
Well, it's a store that sells it.
Oh, it's the store. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I misunderstood what
you
said.
No.
I see.
Yeah.
So they went into
store.
A sporting goods place mm-hmm. and they stole the Hornet stuff.
And then there's a video here, and I'm just going through some of these news feeds that I had gotten last night. Second night of riots in Charlotte. And they looted. Then, of course, there was a shooting.
Yep.
There was a protester on protester shooting, and that guy is on life support. So I guess they decided during the riots they just, take a little revenge on somebody else. And then they tried to toss a photographer onto a small bonfire.
Good grief.
Now, this is stuff here not – I'm looking at the video right now.
I haven't seen that on NBC.
Or CNN or
– No.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
None of it.
And then police officers could be seen reacting within seconds trying to help the photographer get out of the fire. And then
are they still rioting at this moment?
I don't know if they are right now. They may be done since it's about to be daybreak. And
well, one of the quotes that I saw just as I was going to bed last night was someone within the police department who said, "We've been very patient, but it's time to restore the rule of law."
Law. Mm-hmm.
Now, I don't know whether they did or could. Well, you just said they called in the National Guard.
They called in the National Guard, yeah.
So maybe they helped.
Anyway, so these are the things that are happening. These people should be in jail.
Yeah, but nothing ever happens to looters. What happened to the guy who shot this other guy? Do we know who shot him? Did he get in trouble?
Well, it doesn't look like it because it was a crowd of people. I mean, there is video of that where you hear a gunshot and then in the middle of all these people and then they move out of the way and you see the guy on the ground.
My goodness.
That was shot. Let's see here. And then the CNN reporter was tackled on the air. Now, CNN came back later and said, well, that protester came back and apologized for knocking you over. And it's like, really? So that's what's going on right now in Charlotte. And that's the two different stories.
Those are different stories.
Yeah. The family says he was sitting there reading a book, waiting for his kid to get off the bus. The police say that he got out twice with a gun, told to get
I mean, they didn't use the word, but their version of the story would be consistent with an ambush. So they're saying the police ambushed this
basically,
guy.
Basically, yeah. And planted the gun.
And then planted a gun.
Mm-hmm.
So I was telling y'all about this new law that may prevent them from releasing the video. It's House Bill 972 called the Body Cam Bill. It was just signed into law in July. But here's something that I didn't get last night. It doesn't go into effect until October 1st.
Oh.
So it shouldn't bother this issue.
Right.
But what it will do is it exempts police audio and video from the public record.
Why?
Pat McCrory, Governor,
the governor.
Pat mm-hmm. McCrory said that the reason for that is because it's going to protect not only the interests of police, but also of victims, witnesses, and even suspects. But this body cam bill will exempt police audio and video from public record, and the only way you'll be able to get this now, starting October 1st, will be through a court order instead of how you usually do it with a public records request. Those captured on police video or audio can ask to hear that footage or see the footage, but they can also be denied until a judge says show them.
See, I don't know. I would think body camera video would tell the whole story. Maybe it doesn't, but I would think it would, wouldn't you?
I'm assuming they're trying to protect the innocent here because there's other people that might be in a scene not want to be broadcast on national
news. That's true. And there were witnesses that saw the gun.
But we can blur faces.
Yes, we can. Anyway.
That's odd.
It is odd. The more transparency, the better.
A Democrat was quoted as saying it's too restrictive. It makes me feel weird and dirty and greasy and slimy to agree with a Democrat. But I agree with that
guy. Oh, wow, Corey. I didn't know where you were going with that. Mary Lawrence in the house. Let's go to the phone. Hey, Clarence.
Good morning, everybody.
Hey.
Good morning.
Tony, Bonnie and Clyde were bank robbers.
They were bank robbers. That's what they were. Yeah. Did you
Bikers
get that, Corey?
Compared to today.
No, I missed that. What?
It was Clyde Barrow, Bonnie Parker, Willie Sutton, bank robbers. You know, Bonnie and Clyde.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, you didn't say Bonnie and Clyde.
Well, I didn't want to make it so easy for you.
Well, I need
Clarence
it.
Got
I need
it.
Easy.
Clarence got it.
Well, I'm a little older. Bonnie and Clyde were pikers compared to the criminals today.
Oh, tell you what.
Hey, hey Tony, have we heard from the agitator-in-chief?
Not a word.
Wow.
Not
he hasn't addressed the nation and asked for calm?
Not a word. Or Loretta Lynch. Not a word.
So they haven't popped up out of their hole, huh?
No. Mm-mm.
He hasn't read the news yet.
Oh, yeah. He's got to hear it on the news. That's true. That's a great point, Mary.
You know, it's really odd because he really likes to be in front of the camera talking about himself and telling all of us how wonderful he is.
Well, the problem with that is, I was reminded of this yesterday. Remember when he was elected? That this is now a post-racial nation. Well, we're in the worst race. I wouldn't say war, but we're race issues, race relations in this country is worse than they've been since I've been alive that I can remember.
By the way, I've just gotten an alert. They haven't released it yet. We'll see if they do. But according to this, Charlotte police reportedly have video of Keith Scott exiting his car, moving toward police officers with gun in hand.
Well, they need to release that then.
They need to release it, and they need to release it soon.
Yeah.
Because the longer they wait.
Book in hand?
No book. But the. The longer they wait, the more the conspiracy is going to be that they doctored the video. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Tony, how does the family know he was sitting in the car reading a book? How did they know that?
Well, you know, that is a great question.
I mean, has anyone asked them how you knew that?
That is a great question. Not one reporter has asked the family. I'm sorry, were you there too? Because none of his family was there. How did they know that he was sitting in the car reading a book?
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the first thing when I hear the family say he's sitting in the car reading a book. Well, were you in the car?
No, nobody was in the car.
And, Tony, this is a little off the subject, but now you said earlier that Hillary was interviewed in Florida.
Yes.
Now, was she in Florida, or was she like a phone interview interview?
She was actually in Florida.
Okay. All right.
Looked like she had about 200 people in the audience.
Oh, that's okay. So this was several days ago.
Yesterday.
Okay. Well, she talked to a Las Vegas Union yesterday via video. Have you seen that?
Video chat from, yes.
And she asked why she wasn't 50 points ahead?
Yes.
Now, I'm a little older than y'all are, and I don't think even Ronald Reagan or Richard Nixon in his second election. They were both landslides, by the way. I don't think they won by 50 points.
No. Mm-mm. It's going to be an interesting debate, is all I got to say.
I thought she looked awfully fragile in that video.
She did.
She's obviously sitting. I guess they'll be sitting at the debates.
I don't think so.
I've seen them both ways.
But well, I don't think they'll be sitting.
Well, I would be surprised because this woman, I don't think she can stand for an hour, but we'll see.
90 minutes.
And what they're doing to what they did to Matt Lauer and to Jimmy Fallon, in my opinion, is a warning.
It's a warning.
To the ones that are coming up.
Yep, it is. It's a warning. You better fact check Trump and you better be hard on him and not hard on Hillary or else. It's a warning. All right, gotta go, Clarence. You have a good one.
Thanks.
All right, we'll take a break, get back to the phone. Mary Lawrence in the house, don't go away.
Listen to Tony and Gary on your smartphone.
Download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2. And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Tony and Gary.
It's the morning show with Tony and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Talking with Russ and Andy of Last Resort Guns, County Line Road in Madison. You know, Russ, Tactical Tuesdays have been very successful.
Indeed, they have been so successful that we have replicated them as a Saturday matinee of Tactical Tuesday. We're now running Tactical Tuesdays at 6 on a Tuesday, but we're also running the matinee of Tactical Tuesday at 8 on a Saturday morning, so we have doubled the amount of space we've got for people to come and do tactical shooting in the range.
Is that every week?
That'll be every week.
Tactical Tuesday, now also a Saturday matinee. Last Resort Guns, County Line Road in Madison.
Nick Soboleski, a SelectQuote agent with a true story that could save you hundreds of dollars a year. A woman named Linda just called. Her husband, Ray, has a $300,000 group life insurance policy, but is changing jobs and can't take it with him. Well, I impartially shopped the highly rated term life insurance companies we represent and found Ray, who is 41 and takes medication to control his cholesterol, a 10-year, $500,000 policy for under $26 a month. That's almost twice the coverage for less than half of what he had paid. If SelectQuote hasn't shopped for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much.
For your free quote, call 1-800-467-5125. That's 1-800-467-5125. 1-800-467-5125. Or go to SelectQuote.com. We shop, you save. Get full details on the example policy at SelectQuote.com/commercials. Your price can vary depending on your health, issuing company, and other factors. Not available in all states.
Our sold-out 2016 iHeartRadio Music Festival is finally here, where 20 of the biggest artists in the world come together. This year, we've joined forces with Global Citizen, an organization fighting poverty around the world. On Saturday, Usher will begin his day playing the annual Global Citizen Festival in New York Central Park. After his performance, he'll board a plane for Vegas and arrive at our iHeartRadio Music Festival just in time to close the show.
Thank you, iHeart! Thank you, Vegas!
Usher is going coast to coast to fight poverty. Watch him perform Saturday night and learn how you can become a global citizen.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by Stand Up to Cancer.
Keeping an eye on traffic this morning. We're off to a good start. So far, no wrecks or stalls. If you're heading up and down the parkway, 565 looking good. Right now, it's a good ride around Athens and around Decatur. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
I'm Tony Goldwyn. 20 years ago, when my mom had lung cancer, she didn't have many choices. But today, you do. If you've been diagnosed with lung cancer, please visit standuptocancer.org/lungcancer to learn more.
Guys, when it comes to grooming, we're no longer interested in discount chains and unisex salons. Men nowadays demand the warm, personal atmosphere of the barbershop of days gone by, while enjoying man-sized leather chairs, big-screen TVs, and a cold drink. Rooster's Men's Grooming Center has it all for you. They're located at 475 Providence Main Street in Huntsville. Give them a call at Rooster's Men's Grooming Center at 489-0886.
If you're looking for one of the finest dining experiences in the Tennessee Valley, if you're looking for the best, absolute best steaks and the freshest seafood, look no further. Nick's Ristorante on Bailey Cove Road, south of Weatherly in Huntsville, is the place for you. Go by and see our buddy Nick and all the family there waiting to serve you with the best food that Huntsville has seen in years and years at Nick's Ristorante on Bailey Cove Road, just south of Weatherly.
Hey, what are you doing? How do you like the new sign? Sutton and Daughters Furniture? Does Daddy know about this? Well, we can't call it Sutton and Son because we don't have any brothers. And besides, we've helped Daddy in the store practically since we were babies. Sutton and Daughters, that has a nice ring to it. Finally, some respect around here. Laren, this could be the start of a new trend. Either that or World War III.
The brands you trust, like Clayton Marcus and Craftmaster, at a price you'll love.
That's because Daddy said sell it.
Sutton Furniture.
Highway 72 in Athens.
Now, your official WBHP Weather Center forecast.
This report is brought to you by Positive Coaching Alliance.
It's the first day of fall in the Tennessee Valley. A steamy afternoon, high temperatures in the mid-90s. Tonight, mostly clear, down into the upper 60s on Friday. A mostly sunny sky, highs again in the mid-90s. Highs both Saturday and Sunday around 95. We try to cool it off just a little bit heading into next week. Take my forecast and WBHP with you everywhere. Download the free iHeartRadio app at WBHPAM.com.
If you're involved in youth or high school sports, you need to know about Positive Coaching Alliance. PCA is a national nonprofit organization developing better athletes and better people through youth and high school sports. For more information, visit positivecoach.org.
If you really want to protect your vehicle's floor, why would you settle for anything less than the most advanced vehicle floor protection available? I'm David McNeil, founder of WeatherTech. The main goal when we design, engineer, and manufacture our floor liners is to protect your vehicle's floor, period. We realize you've made quite an investment in your vehicle, so we do everything possible to help you protect it. We don't cut corners, and we don't compromise on quality, ever. We test our custom fit WeatherTech floor liners to ensure they hold up against anything and everything that falls on them. Dirt, sand, snow, mud, even food and drinks. And our floor liners are made right here in America, with American raw materials and, of course, American workers. So now that you know how passionate we are about protection, just imagine the detail and energy we put into every aspect of our floor liners. Learn more today about our full line of automotive accessories at WeatherTech.com or call 1-800-CAR-MATS. WeatherTech floor liners, complete protection, completely American made.
Toni and Gary sound better in HD. Listen on your HD radio at 102.1 HD2.
Bankston Motorhomes is the area's only family-owned, best in business award-winning RV dealer in North Alabama, offering the best selection and best values. If Bankston doesn't have it, they don't make it.
Bankston doesn't have it, they don't make it. That's right, 400 units on the lot, low interest.
You know, that's a bold claim, but Bankston Motorhomes can make it. I love it.
Absolutely. Yeah. They don't have it. If they don't make it, they don't have it. They don't. Say that again.
Yeah, whoa. Chase said that much better.
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
If they ain't got it, they don't make it.
They don't make it. So
I don't think he said ain't.
No, he didn't say ain't. He ain't from Athens. No, I'm kidding.
No, he ain't.
Anyway, but it is just a fabulous business. Small business. Been in business for 47, 48 years. The whole family's involved. Rent one. You know, is today the first day of fall? It is.
It is. It's going to be 93 today, but it is the first day of fall.
9 o'clock this morning, something like that.
I don't know what time.
I think 9:22, I think you said, or something like that. Yeah. Mary, how are you?
Very good, thanks.
It feels better out there this morning.
I'm surprised it's fall. But
me too. It's hot. Oh. All right, let's get to the phone. Let's get to Mary. Hey, Mary.
Good morning. Y'all doing all right this morning?
Doing good. Morning. Thank you.
And I just want to get qualified.
You're in there.
Thank you.
And Fred. Hey, Fred.
I want to get qualified, too.
Thank you, Fred.
Thank you.
And Brian?
Hey, I missed the trivia earlier.
All right, so let me give it to you again. All the answers are two words. First word begins with B, as in boy. Second word begins with R, like in run. So the last one that was answered was Clyde Barrow, Bonnie Parker, and Willie Sutton. That would be bank robbers. Okay?
Okay.
Then we have a rodeo event. We have famous barrel racing. Yeah.
Oh, bull riding was my thought.
Or bull riding, either one. Yeah. Bull riding, barrel racing. Very good, Brian.
Mary was saying on her picks, she always picks Alabama and Auburn. Is she going to abstain during the Iron Bowl?
Oh, good point.
I don't know. I guess it depends on which child is doing better in school.
See, I had those two.
Wow.
Alicia, Alabama fan. Cody, Auburn fan. But we have brought Cody.
Where'd you go wrong with Cody?
Well, we've brought him from the dark side.
Oh.
Into the Alabama fold.
Good. But he's still an Auburn fan.
But he's still an Auburn fan.
Yeah, I'm
yes.
a Broncos fan, so Auburn has the right colors, you know?
Yeah. That's true. You'd have to change your whole wardrobe. Well, goodness gracious.
I don't represent.
I know.
You talk about Auburn being the dark side, yet you have a head coach that is only one letter away from Satan.
Wow, Brian. Really? Really?
Well, I like your head coach. I do like him. There's another coach that I don't. I really do. I do highly respect your head coach.
Well, as a Tennessee fan, I can see where you don't like Lane Kiffin.
Yeah, no
kidding. That hurts when you say that name.
I'm sorry, Brian. I didn't mean to cause you pain.
Y'all have a great day. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
You too. And let's see here. Let's get Joe in here. Hey, Joe.
Good morning. How y'all doing?
Good.
Yeah, you know about this Charlotte thing? I'm from North Carolina originally.
Are you really?
And they want to call these people protesters. They're not protesters. They're rioters, plain and simple.
Yeah, right.
And they're out to cause mayhem. And the brother of the guy that got shot, you know, calling white people devils.
Yeah, he said all white people are devils.
Come on, that's from Farrakhan.
But I mean, a white man did not shoot him.
No, a black man shot him.
I understand that.
Okay. But common sense again. Okay. Sorry.
Mary, are we
You're
talking?
You're being too logic.
Mary, those Logical. Are facts. They're not going on facts. Mm-hmm. Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, if they do have this dash cam video, as this alert just said, the police were showing him getting out of his car, coming at the officers with a gun in hand, that would solve the whole problem if they would put that out.
Yeah.
Well, the police chief there in Charlotte, he says they have it, and he's seen it.
Right.
He's positive that the guy had a gun, but because of legal reasons right now, they can't release it.
Yeah.
And I understand that, but a lot of people want to jump to conclusions before they see the evidence.
Well, see, and they don't care. I mean, the same thing with Ferguson, with Michael Brown, the one guy says Michael Brown had his hands up, don't shoot him. And that's, they still protest like that with their hands up, like it's true. It wasn't true. But
yeah.
Truth.
Hands up, don't shoot.
Yeah.
Theory. Yeah.
Truth doesn't matter.
Well, those folks may not even know that it's not true because the media's never told anybody that it's not true.
Well.
Well, they probably don't really care.
Well, that's true, too.
Yeah, anything. Like I said, for you to be a protester and go into the stores and loot and break windows, and the video of the looters is
horrendous.
It is horrendous. Mm-hmm. And, big screen TVs and iPads, and what they did in Baltimore, what did they rob? 4 drugstores of all the narcotics?
Yeah.
They still haven't gotten all those narcotics back.
Well, right. It'd be hard to do.
Yeah, since
they've already been processed
and sold on the street.
Yeah, that's the process. Yeah, I was talking
about.
How many
people get prosecuted?
Why
how
are
many
they
are prosecuted?
Yeah, very few. Very few.
It's a hard thing to do. But cops have a job, and people just got to respect that. I mean, there's bad cops. There's good cops.
Sure,
but you can't lump everybody in the same.
Right. Can't lump everybody together. Thank you, Joe. You have a good one.
It's like Trump's son the other day with the Skittles. You got a handful of Skittles, 4 of them's poisonous. You can't lump all of them just because 4 guys are, 4 would be poisonous. You can't say all the chisels are poisonous.
Yeah, and I think his son put out the tweet about the Skittles got in so much trouble from the media.
Yeah,
it was like, really? But what they were saying is, with the Syrian refugees, is that if you have a bowl full of Skittles and 3 of them are bad or poisonous, are you going to take a handful?
Yep.
And so that was what they were saying about the Syrian refugees. You can bring in, thousands, but if 3 of them are bad and they're going to, do San Bernardino, Orlando, or whatever, is it worth it? And that was basically the analogy.
Yeah.
Thank you, Joe.
Yeah, and the same analogy can be said for, black saying all cops are bad.
Right, that's exactly right. They're not,
All right, y'all have a great day.
Thank you. Can you imagine this country without police? It would be
chaos. There you go.
I mean, it would be chaos.
Yeah.
It would be.
All right, we'll take...
It can be chaotic with the police.
Yeah,
Just as Chicagoans.
Here's something you don't hear every day. Muslim women for Trump.
No, you don't hear that very often.
We'll play the soundbite from the woman herself. We'll be right back. I'll stay
on the bus, forget about it. On your smartphone, download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And listen on your computer free anywhere in the world.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2. And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Toni and Gary.
It's the morning show with Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Hello, Americans. I'm Todd Stearns with this Fox News and Commentary next. If you're familiar with cloud computing, you probably know that Amazon Web Services offers a complete set of secure compute, storage, application, and deployment services that help companies launch and scale their IT infrastructures while lowering costs. But did you know that you're still responsible for protecting your own AWS-based assets, meaning your applications and data, from advanced cyber threats? Protect your AWS with Barracuda Networks Advanced Firewall Solutions. Visit AWS Marketplace or barracuda.com/AWS to learn more.
Police in Charlotte, North Carolina say only one person was arrested after Tuesday night's riots. One person! Hundreds rampaged through the streets, looting stores, setting fires, shutting down Interstate 85. All because of a protest over the shooting death of a black man. Police say the man had a gun. The man's family says he had a book. The incident remains under investigation. Hillary Clinton is making what happened in Charlotte a campaign issue, sending her thoughts and prayers. Well, what about the business owners who got looted? What about them? What about the truck drivers who were attacked on Interstate 85? Or the families who were terrorized in their cars? Or the untold number of police and civilians who were left bloodied and battered by the attack? Something tells me they don't matter. It's time for America to make a decision, folks. We either have the rule of law or we don't. I'm Todd Starnes.
Tired of getting the runaround? You want it, Jimmy Smith Buick GMC. Instead, we invite you to join the Preferred Owner Program. Whether you buy new or used, you'll get preferred treatment, including service. Come take advantage of the best offers of the year. Right now, you can get $9,000 off the Enclave or $5,000 off select Encore.
Come be a part of our family.
You'll find us on Highway 72 on the east side of Athens. Jimmy Smith, Buick GMC.
We're your neighborhood dealer.
If you really want to protect your vehicle's floor, why would you settle for anything less than the most advanced vehicle floor protection available? I'm David McNeil, founder of WeatherTech. The main goal when we design, engineer, and manufacture our floor liners is to protect your vehicle's floor, period. We realize you've made quite an investment in your vehicle, so we do everything possible to help you protect it. We don't cut corners, and we don't compromise on quality, ever. We test our custom-fit WeatherTech floor liners to ensure they hold up against anything and everything that falls on them. Dirt, sand, snow, mud, even food and drinks. And our floor liners are made right here in America, with American raw materials and, of course, American workers. So now that you know how passionate we are about protection, just imagine the detail and energy we put into every aspect of our floor liners. Learn more today about our full line of automotive accessories at WeatherTech.com or call 1-800-CAR-MATS. WeatherTech floor liners, complete protection, completely American made.
This is water. Can you feel this, Helen? Yes, water! Helen, it's water!
Deaf and blind, Helen Keller overcame her world of darkness. Foresight, pass it on. From the Foundation for a Better Life at values.com.
Say good morning to Keith Pinkerton. He is Mr. Electric. Now, Keith, every month we have severe weather in the Tennessee Valley. Power outages, a big problem. But you can help stop that.
That is correct. We can actually come in and install a whole house generator that automatically senses when the power goes off, takes you off the utility grid, and turns on the generator and powers up your house during a power outage. And when power comes back on, it senses it and shuts down the generator and puts you back on the utility grid.
And another important feature with Mr. Electric is making sure you're safe at home.
We actually have a home safety inspection, electrical home safety inspection that we do when we come out to your house. And we inspect your whole electrical system and we educate you about your electrical system. And if we see any code violations or anything that needs to be addressed, we'll give you a free upfront quote.
Call Mr. Electric today at 1-888-536-8119.
When a customer calls Hiller, we ask, how can we make you happy today? And when you work for Hiller, you're treated with the exact same level of care. We hire the right people and treat them the right way. Training extensively and promoting from within.
I started at Hiller 9 years ago as a tech, and now I'm a team leader, and I wouldn't work anywhere else.
So if you want to be part of a professional team that helps you be the best at what you do, give us a call or visit hillerishiring.com and see how we can make you happy today.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by Stand Up to Cancer.
More cars and trucks on the road. Add to that school buses. A reminder to keep an eye out for those kids running around the bus stops this morning. We're not spotting any big delays so far around Athens, around Decatur. No problems on 565 or along the parkway. No problems heading over Chapman Mountain on 72. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
I'm Toni Goldwyn. 20 years ago, when my mom had lung cancer, she didn't have many choices. But today, you do. If you've been diagnosed with lung cancer, please visit standuptocancer.org/lungcancer to learn more.
Say good morning to Mary Lawrence, Sonoma's Mortgage, First Commercial Bank. Okay, Mary, so I want to build a house. What's my first step?
Well, the first step is very similar to buying any house, to get pre-qualified and then to find out your options. So we go through it a little bit differently when you're building, and it's a little bit longer process, but very similar to home buying process for an existing house.
So, Mary, I've decided I want to build a house. But I have to buy a lot, right?
Yes.
And then you're going to help me figure out how to get all the people together that I need to build the house?
And we can be a one-stop shop for that, for buying the lot, for doing the construction loan, for doing the permanent financing, and to find out whether or not you want to do a one-time close or whether it makes more sense to do two closes, depending on the type of loan that you're looking for, the type of down payment, and the equity you might have.
And the thing is, I may not even know that.
Right, because we can be creative on how we come up with the down payment in this scenario. So it's good to have that conversation either before or as you're talking to your builder.
So again, the first stop that I need to make is with you.
It makes sense because you get the whole picture drawn out and kind of a map of where you need to go.
Call Mary Lawrence today on her cell phone, 256-755-1008. All loans subject to credit approval. Rates and fees subject to change. NMLS number 180085.
In the market for a new or pre-owned RV? Let us help you. Hi, this is Chase with Bankston Motorhomes. For over 46 years, my family has helped thousands of people just like you enjoy the RVing lifestyle. Whether you are taking a trip to the beach, exploring the West, tailgating, or just going on a weekend trip with your family, we have something for you. View all of our inventory online at BankstonMotorhomes.com or stop by any of Bankston's five locations here in North Alabama and Southern Tennessee.
Catch PRN's Fast Talk Live tonight at 8 on the Valley's Big Talker, 800 and 1230 WBHP.
I'm Chris Haley with Haley's Flooring and Interiors and Liberty Safes. And we will be giving away a Liberty Tactical Gun Safe, an $1,100 value. Listen for details.
The Toni and Gary SEC Football Pick'em Contest. Find out more online at TonyandGary.com. And listen weekdays 5 to 8 a.m. here on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Welcome back to the morning show. Okay, what are we giving away?
$40 for Popeye's Cajun Fried Chicken. Movie passes for two at Hollywood 18. Family four-pack to the Botanical Gardens. $20 from Dunkin' Donuts, Huntsville and Madison. And today is Big Prize Giveaway Thursday, so we've added $100 to Nick's Ristorante on South Bailey Cove in Huntsville.
And a day pass to the range at Last Resort Guns, County Line Road in Madison.
All you have to do is call us. At the end of the show, we'll draw from all the people who have called in. And that person wins.
534-3521 and 309-2313.
We've added prizes. We have a family four-pack, Tate Farms, and golf for two at Point Mallard's Championship Course. So the game we're playing, two words. First word begins with B, as in boy. Second word begins with R, like run, okay? So earlier we had, for example, a rodeo event, bull riding, barrel racing, whichever. He was most famous for portraying Sherlock Holmes. That's an old question. Or this ice cream company known for 31 flavors, BR, a prime cut of bovine meat. Quasimodo, a cinnamon-flavored gum made by Wrigley's, B-R, a pool or snooker table may be found here. Let's see here, what else? A digital optical disc data storage format.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And one more. known for...
Mary just threw her hands up.
Me too. It was like, if I didn't have the answer right here, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, you had trouble giving the clue.
I did. I had to say it very slowly. Known for his Battle of the Sexes with Billie Jean King. Okay, we have several of these. Huh. Let's see, I want to get to this one. This is for our... for our NASA people. Mm-hmm. The first stage of a multi-stage launch vehicle. The first stage of a multi-stage launch vehicle. BR. You know that one? Now you're looking at me like, huh?
No, I don't.
Phone numbers are?
256-534-3521 or 309-2313. Just an FYI, 55.
Okay.
Is where we need to go.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. And Bob. Hey, Bob.
Hey, good morning. I love this trivia this morning. I do know the answer to the NASA one, but it's not every day you get to say the name Basil Rathbone on the radio.
There you go. Oh. Very good. Yeah, no, that was the original guy that portrayed Sherlock Holmes. Very good.
Yeah, even last night, one of my kids asked me to order the complete Sherlock Holmes audio so they could listen to it. It is still popular.
Yeah, it is still popular. Uh-huh. I love Sherlock Holmes. Mm-hmm. The new ones, too. You know, I love them all.
Hey, my first thought of the whole thing was BR stands for bad refugees. so I wanted to ask a question. Are these really refugees? Because by definition... you seek refuge until you can go back. Is that the plan?
No, it's not the plan. It's not the plan to go back. It's the plan to give them citizenship to become a voting bloc.
Yeah, they're on the fast track for citizenship once they get here.
The story we had a couple of days ago about Department of Homeland Security that gave citizenship to 858 illegals by accident.
Mm-hmm.
1,800 got citizenship.
Oh,
they lied.
They rounded that one up, didn't they?
And let me tell you where there are no Syrian refugees. Let me tell you where there are Syrian. So there's a Stone Mountain, Georgia, a city of just over 6,000 residents.
Yeah.
Poverty rate well above the national average, has resettled more Syrian refugees than L.A. and New York combined. Now, where do they not have not one Syrian refugee? That would be Nancy Pelosi's district.
Of course.
Not one. And that's what they're doing. They're putting refugees into red states in order to change the dynamic of that state, change red states to blue. Yep. So what they're doing, Bob.
Well, stop calling them refugees. Call them immigrants.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Thank you, Bob.
All right, bye-bye.
And
bye-bye.
Royce. Hey, Royce.
Good morning. We'll go with Bobby Riggs.
Bobby Riggs.
Very good.
Yeah. Little tennis there.
Oh, yeah. Slept on our new pillows last night.
What kind of pillows did you get?
MyPillow.com.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
How are they?
We loved them.
Hmm.
You can buy the generic version from Walmart that is really the original MyPillow, but a lot of changes have been made, and so when you really have to do the, when you call and give the promo code, buy one, get one free, they're still at the same price as what you pay at Walmart for a little nicer MyPillow.com. So
they need to
I do recommend
you.
It. So when you call in, just tell the promo code Royce, and you will get the buy one, get one free.
So, how much were they?
$100.
For two. A pillow?
For two.
Yes, ma'am.
$100? Well, that's the reason I haven't ordered a MyPillow. I don't care. You could have said $100 for five, and I still would have said $100.
Do you know how much the last pillow? Do you know how much I paid for the last pillow I bought? Two for $5 at Walmart.
I know, right?
But listen, with y'all's sleep schedule, you need these.
Listen,
you'll go to sleep quicker, you will sleep deeper, you will wake up refreshed, there'll be no neck pain, it'll be worth it.
Listen, but you'll
think
be
about
broke
what you pay for a copayment when you go to the doctor or the chiropractor.
Right.
Buy you a pillow.
I bought four of them so that, you know, because they don't stay.
That'd be $200.
They don't keep their shape long. You know, so
you can wash and dry these. 10-year warranty.
I'm not paying $100 for a pillow.
Royce is sold.
He is sold. He must be getting a percentage. Thank you, Royce.
Let me say this. There are good cops. There are bad cops.
Yeah.
There are good cops that make mistakes.
Yes.
I don't hear that a lot.
Yeah, that's true.
Some of these are just mistakes. They're not bad cops. They're just messed up. And by the way, white people get killed too by cops.
More white people get killed by cops than black people. We'll be right back.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by Boys and Girls Club of America.
More cars and trucks on the road. Add to that school buses. A reminder to keep an eye out for those kids running around the bus stops this morning. We're not spotting any big delays so far around Athens, around Decatur. No problems on 565 or along the parkway. No problems heading over Chapman Mountain on 72. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
It's 3 p.m. School's out for America's kids. And when school's out, clubs are in. It's time to support the Boys and Girls Clubs. Visit greatfutures.org.
This is PD. Get on down to Yearwood Equipment today, where the deals have never been hotter on new Kubota tractors. You can get low payments for up to 84 months with 0% APR, incredible customer instant rebates, and a 6-year powertrain limited warranty on BX, BL, and MX tractors. There have never, ever been deals like these. Stop by Yearwood Equipment in Fayetteville today.
Now through 12/31/16, call toll-free 800-794-4992 for details about cost and terms. For complete warranty details, see Kubota.com or your authorized Kubota dealer.
It's home improvement time.
If you're looking for a reliable, on-time painter, there's one company that goes the extra mile, Marathon Painting. And Marathon Painting can do so much more, including roofing, remodeling, repairs, and more. And Marathon Painting is part of our Home Experts team. Find out more at WBHPAM.com, keyword Home Experts.
This is Gary Sullivan. Hope you'll join me in a little home improvement talk this Sunday afternoon at 3 here on WBHP.
It's frustrating driving with those things that are just not right on your car. The rattles, the squeaks, the radio you can't program.
It is time for a new ride, and it's time to visit your North Alabama Honda dealer.
No worries in a brand new 2016 Honda Civic.
And don't just take my word for it. Take the word of the 55 automotive experts who gave the Civic the prestigious North American Car of the Year award.
There's only one Car of the Year, and you can get it at your North Alabama Honda dealer.
The Honda Civic can be yours, and it's spectacular with improved fuel economy.
42 miles per gallon.
And improved horsepower.
Up to 174.
So now, in addition to great looks, Apple CarPlay, and fuel economy,
you've got power. Power in a Civic.
So you need to hurry to any North Alabama Honda dealer for your brand new 2016 Honda Civic. Lease is starting at $179 a month.
Shop Jerry Damson Honda in Huntsville, Honda of Decatur on the Beltline, or University Honda in Florence.
I'm Toni Goldwyn. 20 years ago, when my mom had lung cancer, she didn't have many choices, but today you do. If you've been diagnosed with lung cancer, please visit standuptocancer.org/lungcancer to learn more.
Talking with Andy Jones of Last Resort Guns, County Line Road in Madison, a variety of pistol courses offered at Last Resort. Andy, tell us about
that. Yes, we're trying to come up with a number of different ways that we can reach out to people and help educate them as part of our classes. We've started running an introduction to pistol shooting class, which is primarily aimed at beginner shooters or those with not very much confidence or experience of actually shooting a handgun. And it's the shooting element, so it's going in the range and having some instruction on stance and aiming and actually getting the experience and practice with an instructor to go through the shooting. We've also started an NRA course, which is called the First Steps, and it's specific to a handgun type, be it a revolver or a pistol, which is how it allows us to limit the time. And then, of course, we've got the NRA Basic Pistol class, and that covers all forms of handguns.
Visit Last Resort Guns in Madison on County Line Road just south of Palmer Road, or give them a call today, 256-774-5741. That's Last Resort Guns.
This is WBHP Huntsville, WHOS Decatur, and WDRM-FM HD2 Decatur, an iHeart radio station.
Fox News Radio. I'm Lillian Wu. A state of emergency in Charlotte, North Carolina, where there was a second night of violence over a police shooting of a man. One person last night allegedly shot in the head.
That's what we can tell right now. It was the civilian-on-civilian shooting. That person is in critical condition in the hospital. There was at least one officer injured as well.
Charlotte Mayor Jennifer Roberts telling the Fox Business Network that there were some businesses with windows smashed. Some protesters placing blame for last night's shooting on officers. Fox's Steve Harrigan.
So really we're seeing two different versions of what happened. An official version and a version believed by many of the protesters. When that shot rang out, we just saw them run down this hill saying the police shot another one.
And the Syrian president blaming the U.S. for the collapse of a ceasefire deal, calling U.S. airstrikes on Syrian troops definitely intentional. Fox News, we report, you decide.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by Boys and Girls Club of America.
It's getting crowded on 565 eastbound, starting at I-65, making your way past the airport. A lot of folks heading into the arsenal this morning. Of course, it's slow around the parkway, around Martin Road. Some road work going on there. Right now, no problems on 72 heading over Chapman Mountain. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
It's 3 p.m. School's out for America's kids. And when school's out, clubs are in. It's time to support the Boys and Girls Clubs. Visit greatfutures.org.
Say good morning to Janet Kincheloe Martin, Calhoun Community College. And Janet, let's talk about people who may be a class or two away from graduating.
We're going back through records and have discovered that we've got a lot of students that were Calhoun students at one point, but for whatever reason, they either transferred before they got their associate's degree, or they maybe had to drop out because of life happening, and they were a class or two from graduating and maybe didn't realize how close they were. So we're kind of reclaiming those individuals. If you think that you are a class or two, or you're not certain, we're asking them to contact our advising center. And even if they've gone on to a four-year institution, they can transfer those credits back and we will still award their associate's degree. And someone might say, well, why is that important if they're at a four-year institution now? Well, again, as I said earlier, sometimes life happens. And so if you have enough credits to get that associate's degree, we will award that. You have that degree in hand, and then you can go on and do, you know, what goes on beyond that.
Log on to calhoun.edu to register today.
Talking with Bo Thomas of Thomas HVAC, your train comfort specialist. Tell us about the new technology, Bo.
Well, Gary, this is the same technology. It's been used on airplanes for decades. It's been used to keep out dust, bacteria, viruses, allergens, and now we have it available for your home and your office.
So how does it work?
What we do, we install it into your system, so as it's running, we get a chance to filter the air throughout the whole house.
Well, Bo, what about the people who use humidifiers?
Well, we've got that covered, too. We've got a humidifier we'll install in the system so we can affect the entire house, and we can get rid of those bowls that are sitting over in the corner and eliminate using them in a room-by-room basis. Imagine all day and all night while you're sleeping, the air in your home is being cleaned so you get the best air quality in every room 24 hours a day.
How do they get a hold of you, Bo?
Call us at 256-858-4822 or find us online at coolhuntsville.com.
If money's tight at your house, find out how to achieve financial peace with Dave Ramsey. Weekdays 11 to 2 on WBHP.
Hey, this is Bo Thomas with Thomas HVAC Company. It's football season. That means I'll be giving away $100 in cash to one Toni and Gary listener each week.
The Toni and Gary SEC Football Pick'em Contest. Find out more online at TonyandGary.com and listen weekdays 5 to 8 a.m. here on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
.705 on the morning show. We have tons still to talk about. Mary Lawrence is in the house. We'll get to the phone in a second. So, Mary, I understand that Yellen, Miss Yellen,
yes,
decided that she wasn't going to raise rates today, but they meet again 3 days before the election. And will they decide again? What do you think's going on there?
They won't raise them, I don't believe, until December.
Do you think she'll So you don't think she'll raise them in November either, right?
No, no. I really don't. That's the beauty of buying a house in an election year. Rates are typically steady through the election.
Yeah. So we only have about, 47 days to the election. So if people want to buy a house or refinance a house or renovate a house, they better do it now.
Lock in, yes.
Lock it in now because she is, they keep saying, the media keeps saying that she's independent, but she's a political appointee from the Obama administration,
right, yeah,
which is one of the reasons why they're keeping interest low. They on the political aspect, they want to help Hillary. They don't want to hurt her.
Right, and his legacy.
So take advantage of an election year, like you say, refinancing. Talk about that a minute, because that can help so many different people in so many different ways.
Right. If you know you're going to live in your house for a little while, it makes sense. And you can refinance so that you can get the benefit, really, from day one. You know, you don't have to pay the closing costs. You can take a lower rate. And if it makes sense, you're still not out of pocket any money. And even if you sell shortly, you'd still benefit immediately.
Yes. And that's important. No closing costs.
Right.
No closing costs, folks. Call Mary, no closing costs. You could save $100. Now, there's two or three different things. Let's say that you just want to shorten the life of the loan on your home. You could save hundreds of thousands of dollars off
by
the life of your loan.
By moving it down to a 10 or 15 year. Absolutely.
Exactly. And your payment wouldn't be any higher, and in most cases, it's lower.
Sometimes, yeah. Yeah.
And so you have saved hundreds of thousands of dollars in a lot of cases.
It's amazing.
It's amazing. Yeah. Now, the other side of that coin is, let's say that you want to fix up your house. You want to put in an outdoor kitchen or a new deck, one of my favorite things to talk about, or pay for college or consolidate all your bills.
It's a perfect time to do
that. Perfect time to do that, yeah. And so you could do that and take the equity and pay all your bills off and just have one payment, that one house payment, right?
Right, and sometimes you need that for your budget, you know, especially if things have changed on your income.
Mm-hmm. So there's so many different reasons why to refinance, but I don't see a bad reason anywhere.
Well, yeah, and if it doesn't make sense, we'll go over that with you.
Right,
yeah.
And it doesn't take long.
No, it doesn't. Mm-mm.
No closing costs, folks. Call Mary Lawrence. What's your number, Mary?
256-755-1008.
So a couple of other stories real quick. It looks like now that a very frustrated federal judge has now ordered the State Department to begin producing within 5 days hundreds of documents, from former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and her top aides. Now, these are the documents that the Freedom of Information Act lawsuit that was put against them, that they wanted to know about the security training, the briefings. You know, Hillary Clinton said she couldn't remember if she had been taught how to take care of classified information, remember? That's what she said to the FBI.
I remember that she couldn't remember.
Yes. Yeah. I don't recall. Remember that? That was one of the I don't recalls to the
That's
FBI.
That's right, yeah.
So they filed a lawsuit, Freedom Information Act lawsuit, about all of this, about whether her top aides, Huma, Cheryl Mills, and others, had received the mandatory screening briefings about the proper handling of classified materials. And how to take care of those. And
so we're trying to find out whether or not they were briefed or taught.
Did they have the training? Did she? You know, she signed a form.
And we had to go to a judge in order to find this out.
Yes, she signed a form saying she had the briefing. But
I've seen the form.
You know, we posted the form with her signature on it.
Yes.
But that didn't matter. To the FBI, it was, I can't recall. So they sued, and the judge, Judge Richard Leon, told her and the State Department to release all that stuff. Well, they've been stonewalling, you know, blah, 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 blah. And he said, you know what? I'm done with this. I told you to release it. Now you have 5 days from
yesterday.
5 days
from yesterday?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 5 days to release it.
Thursday, Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
And what he said is you have to release.
That's Wednesday.
He ordered them to release 1/3 of the 400 documents by September 26th.
A third.
And the rest of them by October 10th.
That's Monday.
Yeah. And the rest of them by October 10th.
So he's counting the weekends.
Now, State Department said
Well, he didn't say 5 business days. He said 5 days.
5 days. The State Department said, well, you know, we've been trying to get all this stuff together. But we just don't have the manpower, the money, or the resources. Right, yeah.
What'd they say? It would take 75 years or something?
Yeah, so to get all of it together. Yeah,
how
something
ridiculous.
Like that. And he said, you got 5 days. Wow. Release it no matter what.
Yeah.
And then the rest by October 10th. So,
Wow. One
of the attorneys said that Judge Leon's order made clear his frustration with the State Department and their continued obstruction, and he's had it. So,
Will he enforce his ruling?
Well, what happens?
I know he's trying.
What happens if they don't?
Yeah.
Right.
Well, they'll be in contempt, right?
And then what? So what?
I mean, wasn't Eric Holder in contempt?
Yeah, what happened to him?
Nothing.
Nothing. We'll see.
I went and watched Snowden this weekend.
Oh, did you go see it?
Yes.
And how was it? Was it put in the terms of he's a hero, or was it put in the terms of he's a traitor?
No, it was put in terms of that his conscience wouldn't allow him to do anything else. So more of I can't go on with this knowledge without letting people know, and I hope
whistleblower.
Yeah. And he's in Russia because he can't go anywhere else. They revoked his passport. So he didn't plan to stay there. That's just where he is.
Talking to Putin?
I don't know. He didn't say.
He didn't say.
I didn't realize he was 29 years old, though.
Yeah, he's very young.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, here's another one. Our CIA director, John Brennan.
Mm-hmm.
You know, who has talked about the love of Islam and everything,
yeah,
you know.
He's Muslim.
He's Muslim.
Mm-hmm.
It has now been found out that in 1976, he voted for the Communist Party.
Of course he did.
Our CIA director, John Brennan, he told a congressional panel last week that he froze while taking a CIA polygraph test 4 years later. When the questioner asked him if he had ever worked with or for a group that was dedicated to overthrowing the U.S.
Well, and he froze because he didn't know how to answer that.
He said, this was back in 1980. Yeah. I thought back to a previous election where I voted, and I voted for the Communist Party candidate. And he said...
So in 1980, we had a Communist Party candidate on the ballot?
Well, I didn't think so, but I was trying to find... I guess it was Gus Hall. He said he decided to acknowledge his vote for Communist Gus Hall, the Communist Party USA's 4-time presidential. I guess he's ran before.
Obviously.
When he was undergoing the lie detector test. He said, I said I was neither Democratic or Republican, but it was my way, as I was going to college, of signaling my unhappiness with the system, so I voted for the Communists. Okay. CIA Director John Brennan. Who'd thunk it, right?
Wow.
How far we have come. Mm-mm-mm. I have other stories that we need to get to, but let's get to the phone. Hey, Sherry.
Good morning.
Hey.
Good morning.
I guess I won't get on my soapbox today. I just wanted to try some trivia today to try to get qualified.
All right. What do you think?
Baskin-Robbins.
Baskin-Robbins. That would be 31 flavors. Very good, Sherry.
Well, thank you, and y'all keep doing a great job.
Thank you. And Ralph. Hey, Ralph, how are you?
Morning.
Hey.
Morning.
The first stage is a booster rocket.
It's a booster rocket. That's what it is.
Oh, of course.
First stage of a multi-stage launch vehicle would be the booster rocket.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's silly season this weekend. All the lead up to the debate.
I'll tell you what. It's interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, the conspiracies are flowing, that's for sure.
It's going to be, may you live in interesting times.
Yeah, we do, don't we? Thank you, Ralph. You have a great day.
Bye-bye.
And Alice. Hey, Alice.
Good morning. Tony, do you remember on Tuesday when Philip fell asleep and was snoring?
Yep.
Oh, that's my son, and today's his birthday. I'd like to wish him a happy birthday.
Well, happy birthday, sleepyhead.
Well, we thought he was joking. Did he really fall asleep while he was on hold?
He don't remember calling you.
What?
Oh, my gosh.
He works at night, and he tries to call every morning a little while, but he fell asleep. He don't remember it.
That was real.
Yeah, I thought he was faking it because he'd been on hold so long.
And I want to wish him happy birthday.
Well, there you go, Alice.
Happy birthday, Philip.
Well, now we've just embarrassed him in front of everybody. So
he's sleeping.
He's probably sleeping, yes. Thank you, Alice.
Wow.
Good grief. All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back. We still have a lot to get to, including the question was posed from CNN to the Trump people. Will Donald Trump go personal on Hillary Clinton during the debate? Because if he did, that has never, ever been done before.
Huh? What?
We want to play something for you. When we get back, don't go away.
Listen to Toni and Gary on your smartphone.
Download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2. And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Toni and Gary.
It's the morning show with Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
I'm Nick Soboleski, a SelectQuote agent with a true story that could save you hundreds of dollars a year. A woman named Linda just called. Her husband, Ray, has a $300,000 group life insurance policy, but is changing jobs and can't take it with him. Well, I impartially shopped the highly rated term life insurance companies we represent and found Ray, who is 41 and takes medication to control his cholesterol, a 10-year, $500,000 policy, for under $26 a month. That's almost twice the coverage for less than half of what he had paid. If SelectQuote hasn't shopped for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much.
For your free quote, call 1-800-467-5125. That's 1-800-467-5125. 1-800-467-5125. Or go to SelectQuote.com. We shop, you save. Get full details on the example policy at SelectQuote.com/commercials. Your price can vary depending on your health, issuing company, and other factors. Not available in all states.
Gary Dobbs here talking with Stuart Tanksley, a pro fence of the Tennessee Valley. Stuart, tell us what you do.
We build just about any kind of fence you want within reason, obviously. We try to ensure that our customers get what they pay for, mm-hmm. and they get the best value. I like to sell people on quality instead of price, but there's an old adage that says, you know, you get what you pay for.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's something that we're proud to stand behind. You know, we build a better quality product by taking extra steps and extra measures that we don't charge extra for. And, you know, being a small business versus some of our competitors, we don't have the huge overhead.
And with lower overhead, you can pass that savings along to your customers. So give ProFence a call. Talk to Stuart Tanksley. The number is 584-0092. That's 256-584-0092. If you want a fence built right and you want to save money, you need to be talking to ProFence.
Sean Hannity.
America, your country is under attack. And in 50 days from now, you're going to make a choice in an election. I keep telling you this is a choice election. I keep saying it's a choice election. Keep Obamacare, get rid of Obamacare. It's a choice. It's a choice. Education back to the states, not back to the states. It's a choice. Fix the VA or say it's fine. It's a choice. Rebuild the military or cut military spending. It's a choice.
Weekdays, 2 to 5 p.m. on 800 and 1230 WBHP. The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by Huntsville Hospital.
It's getting crowded on 565 eastbound, starting at I-65, making your way past the airport. A lot of folks heading into the arsenal this morning. Of course, it's slow around the parkway, around Martin Road. Some road work going on there. Right now, no problems on 72 heading over Chapman Mountain. I'm Captain Carl in the Hard East Traffic Center.
When I don't feel good, it's hard to keep up with school, work, even weekend plans. Huntsville Hospital Walk-In Clinic across from Holy Spirit School on Airport Road is open until 6 p.m. every day, including Saturday and Sunday. Huntsville Hospital Walk-In Clinic. We can make you feel all better.
We're here with John Lassick, Floor Coverings International. We've talked about how you make it so easy, so simple, so stress-free that you guys come to people's houses, to their businesses.
We bring a fully stocked, fully wrapped showroom to your home in a van with over 3,000 products in it.
What if you have somebody like me, I don't know what I want, and in your 3,000 different samples, it's not exactly what I want. What happens then?
We just take the van home. Our design consultant starts researching, trying to figure out what you do need or what you might be looking for. And she'll come back with that van and bring you another set of samples. And we'll keep doing that until we find what you're looking for.
And Beth did exactly that.
Mm-hmm.
She found what I was looking for. She brought it back to the house, mm-hmm. and it's installed now.
Yeah. And because we deal with the manufacturers direct and we have such buying power, we can get just about anything that anyone finds.
If they want it, you can find it.
Call Floor Coverings International today and schedule your free in-home design consultation. 256-650-1200.
Now, your official WBHP Weather Center forecast. This report is brought to you by the USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
It's the first day of fall in the Tennessee Valley. A steamy afternoon, high temperatures in the mid-90s. Tonight, mostly clear, down into the upper 60s on Friday. A mostly sunny sky, highs again in the mid-90s. Highs both Saturday and Sunday around 95. We try to cool it off just a little bit heading into next week. Take my forecast at WBHP with you everywhere. Download the free iHeartRadio app at WBHPAM.
Wash surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water while preparing food. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year, and roughly 3,000 will die. But you can keep your family safer by cleaning with soap and water as you go. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
If you run a business, whether you're in plumbing, HVAC, or construction, you know that commercial vans aren't one size fits all. Some vans are too small.
We're gonna have to make 2 trips.
Others too big.
Watch the top! Watch the top!
You need a van that's just right. That's where the Mercedes-Benz Metris comes in. It's the only available mid-size commercial van with unmatched safety features, a 2,500 2-pound payload, and enough cargo space to hold over 60 sheets of 4x8 drywall. It's big enough for the job, yet it's small enough to fit in your garage. It has a service interval of up to 15,000 miles and the highest residual value in its class, according to ALG. We won't give you a one-size-fits-all van. We'll do you one better, a commercial van that's sized just right for you. The 2016 midsize Metris. Mercedes-Benz. Vans born to run.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Join me this afternoon, 2 to 5, for the Sean Hannity Show. Now more with Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
I'm Curie Rosenblum with Rosenblum Realty, and we'd like to make that dream of homeownership a reality for you in 2016. Give us a call at 256-539-9501 or rosenblumrealty.com.
Thank you, Carrie. You know, you buy your house from Carrie Rosenblum, and then you really ought to call Mary first, Mary Lawrence, and find out how much house you can buy. Right, Mary?
That's
a way to do it.
That's a good plan.
And
yes.
You get your little letter. You get your letter that says, yeah, I can. And then when you go buy your house or you go look for housing, you say, here's my letter. So I'm pre-qualified.
Talking about Carrie, you know, listing houses right now, it is in Huntsville a seller's market. Houses are... I think last month they were only on the market an average of 83 days, and you figure it takes 30 or so days to close a loan. So that's selling your house quickly.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is fast. I was just trying to get an update on the state of emergency in North Carolina, but pretty much, and we'll go back through that again in a second. But I wanted to update you on this DHS, this report. So the Department of Homeland Security puts out this report every year. And for some reason, they weren't putting it out to the public this year, so we had to do a little investigating. And what it tells you is how many people actually crossed the border, how many they caught crossing the border. And they said they were catching about 80% of the people. Well, that was a lie. They were only catching about 50% of the, or 47% of the people. And then we find out about this... IG report, this Inspector General report. Now, we told you about this earlier in the week, that the Inspector General had found 858 people had fake identities that were not discovered because Department of Homeland Security, something was odd with their digital fingerprint, and that wasn't available. And so they accidentally... Department of Homeland Security gave these illegal immigrants, criminal illegal immigrants,
whoops,
citizenship.
Whoops.
Not green cards so they could work. Made them U.S. citizens.
Votable people.
They can vote in November. Now, then we found out on Tuesday that it wasn't 858. It was 953. So they were a little wrong in their their numbers.
They were, you know, less than 100 off. That's not bad, Toni.
Yeah. And then we find out yesterday. So now we have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, right? Then we find out yesterday that, you know, even though these 953 people were supposed to be deported.
Yeah.
Instead, they were given U.S. citizenship.
Yeah.
That actually they had messed up that number one more time.
Oh.
It's now 1,811 people. Now,
they need to stop releasing numbers until they're finished counting.
Well, you know, it's those little, you know, you got these little jelly beans at Homeland Security. One, two. So now we know that there's 1,811 people who were supposed to have been deported who were given U.S. citizenship.
They just picked up the wrong form?
Who knows?
Wow.
But the most important part of this is we're not talking about people from Mexico. Every one of the 1,811 people who were given U.S. citizenship were from special interest countries.
What does that mean?
That means terrorist countries.
Which
U.S. officials are concerned about.
Were they
about.
Refugees? Or?
No. They were illegals. They were here illegally.
They did come here illegally.
Yes. And they were ready to be deported because the U.S. was concerned about them in terms of national security.
So they were so concerned that they gave them citizenship.
They were so concerned about them that they were supposed to be immediately deported.
Mm-hmm.
Back to their special interest country, wherever that is. They won't tell us where it is.
Probably a Middle Eastern country.
Yeah.
Or maybe Iran.
But instead, they gave them U.S. citizenship. Now, most of these people had fake IDs, they had filed for their citizenship under a fake ID.
Right. Well, because...
Okay, so according to law... If you give erroneous information to get citizenship papers, they can revoke it. They can take it back from you and deport you.
Right.
The thing is where are...
That was our question earlier this week when we thought it was 800.
Yeah. What do you do?
What
are you doing?
When are they gathering them up now or what's going on?
Well, the thing is where are they?
They don't know. Great.
1,811... individuals from special interest countries that were given U.S. citizenship that can't be found?
Yeah, not only were they, are they, you know, 1,800 illegal immigrants who were given citizenship, they were 1,800 illegal immigrants that they were afraid of
for national security reasons.
And what? Yet they can't track
who
them.
Who are these people that are running our country?
Holy cow.
Can you believe that? I mean...
I'm surprised we don't have more terrorist acts in this country.
Funny you should say that.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Let's see. Where is that paper?
Where is that tree?
No, I can't find that one. But I have a list. You know I have a list. Anyway, I'll get to this list as soon as I find it here in this stack. But I can't help it. Too many things.
Uh-huh.
But the list
shows...
Well,
you can't just pull it up on the computer. The computer's liable to go off.
Well, no, I know. This list... Oh, here it is. I found it.
Good.
I sound like Rush Limbaugh, you know?
You do.
show prep.
Well, you know, he uses us for show prep.
I'm sure he does.
I can't tell you how many times people say, you know what? I heard it. Rush, are you listening?
I'm sure he does. I don't think Mary's buying it.
That was sincere.
Did you not think that was sincere? I thought it was sincere.
For some reason, I didn't
Did you think she was being facetious?
I didn't catch the sincerity in that, no.
Islamic terrorists have killed twice as many people on American soil in the past 12 months than all of the years since 9/11 combined.
Oh, wow.
So let me give you the list.
Yeah.
Orlando nightclub, 49. San Bernardino, 14. Chattanooga, 5. In 2014, Washington and New Jersey, there was a killing spree there. Four. The Oklahoma beheading, remember that? One. Boston Marathon, four. That's not counting how many people were injured, just how many died. Little Rock, one. Fort Hood, 13. The Seattle Jewish Federation shooting, one. And the LA Airport, two. So there have been more people. That's 94, by the way. Islamic terrorists have killed twice as many Americans on U.S. soil in the past 12 months than of all the years since 9/11 combined. So,
wow.
I mean, it's really amazing when you think about it. I mean, like George W. Bush or not, or agree with him or not, we didn't have any terror attacks.
Right, and the recent things over the weekend were just because the bombs didn't go off.
Yeah, just because of the bomb. And they're looking for other people. Hmm. By the way, they had a security analyst on CNN the other day, and we don't have time to play it because I want to play Michelle Obama, okay? I want to get that on here. That said, well, what it was is there's no cell out there. It's lone wolves who have gotten together to plan this. I'm sorry, isn't a lone wolf somebody who does it on their own?
Yes.
So, but what he was said is, what's probably happened is there's several lone wolves have gotten together.
Well, they're no longer lone wolves. Well,
but that's not what he said. He said, no, it's not a cell. They're lone wolves who have gotten together.
Well,
what a dummy.
Is it at least a group?
No, they're lone wolves. They don't want to
several lone wolves
several
together.
Several have gotten together, yes. But it's right. Not a cell. All now, right. This is how dumb CNN is. All right, Michelle Obama. Should Trump go negative on Hillary Clinton? What happens, not negative, but personal? Should he talk about Bill Clinton? Because CNN said nobody's ever done that before. You really shouldn't bring up Bill or, you know, any of his affairs or any of that, right? Let's go back to 2008 and Michelle Obama talking about Hillary Clinton. Here we go.
Campaigning in Chicago, Michelle Obama today told women why her husband should be the next president of the United States.
One of the things, the important aspects of this race is role modeling what good families should look like. And my view is that if you can't run your own house, you certainly can't run the White House. Can't do it.
Right. So, Hillary, Michelle Obama did it. That's different, though, right?
Yeah, that wasn't personal.
That wasn't personal. Let's go to Kelly. Hey, Kelly. Kelly. Oh, Kelly.
Hey,
Kelly. How are you?
Great. We haven't called in so long, but today I was calling because it's Happy Fall, my favorite season of the year, and Emma is 12 today. Last year before I have two teenagers, so she was listening and she goes, "Mama, am I on the radio?" And I'm like, "Yes, Emma." At 12 years old, and we gave her a cell phone. Oh my gosh, that was her number one gift.
Isn't that something?
Kelly, that is crazy. I made Michael wait until 13, so he was furious.
Kelly, I must ask, what is our classroom pet this year?
Okay, since you're asking, I'm actually in the classroom, and the boys and girls are here, and we're feeding the animals. I have three ferrets, Clover, Izzy, and Crimson, two chinchillas, Puck and Puff. The treat is where they've all been gathered, a jumbo rabbit named Daryl with silky ears weighing in at 9 pounds. Four turtles, a hamster, a guinea pig named Rolette, a hermit crab that ran away from home, but we have him, a gerbil with a bad attitude, an assortment of fish, and four birds, one's expecting.
I didn't know.
Wow.
I didn't know, Kelly, that your classroom was at a zoo.
It is. I'm the lower school science specialist for Randolph, and so I'm kind of like Miss Frizzle, and so
yes.
But I love life science, and so... This is the before kids that are in here right now when they're checking out fossils and things, but they've come to feed the animals. And
wow.
Well, Miss Frizzle, you need
like,
an iguana.
You have the animals and not us.
So the crab ran away from home, did you say?
Yes. I had a parent that came last week with this beautiful hermit crab, and she said, "We found this on our porch, and it's obviously a beautiful decorator shell. I think she said that they probably got sick of him and threw him away, but he has run to our porch. And we knew that you would take care of him. So now Kermit the Hermit also has moved in.
Kermit the Hermit.
I love it.
You know, I don't think I have ever seen a crab running around the streets in my neighborhood.
I haven't, but this one did. So he was meant to come to me, I think.
That is something. Very good. Kelly, you have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. What a great story.
No kidding.
We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Thank you for being a friend.
Listen to Toni and Gary on your smartphone.
Download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2. And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Toni and Gary.
It's the Morning Show with Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Who makes the tastiest made-from-scratch biscuits in the South? Hardee's, of course. Now, enjoy two country fried steak biscuits for only $3. That's right, two for $3 steak biscuits now at your neighborhood Hardee's restaurant.
The CarPro, Jerry Reynolds.
Got a question? Ask it now. Just go to carprousa.com or join us on Facebook by hitting the link at carprousa.com.
Saturdays noon to 3 and Sundays 9 to 11 a.m. on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
Hey, it's George Norrie from Coast to Coast AM, and I want to chat with you about your business. If you want to grow it, you need to connect with your audience. But how do you do that? With iHeartMedia. We create and distribute more live content to connect your brands to than any other media company in the world, making sure the right message reaches the right people at the most relevant times. Call 844-BY-RADIO. That's 844-BY-RADIO, or simply go to iHeartMedia.com. Get heard, be loved, grow your business with iHeartMedia.
Guys, when it comes to grooming, we're no longer interested in discount chains and unisex salons. Men nowadays demand the warm, personal atmosphere of the barbershop of days gone by, while enjoying man-sized leather chairs, big-screen TVs, and a cold drink. Rooster's Men's Grooming Center has it all for you. They're located at 475 Providence Main Street in Huntsville. Give them a call at Rooster's Men's Grooming Center at 489-0886.
If you're looking for one of the finest dining experiences in the Tennessee Valley, if you're looking for the best, absolute best steaks and the freshest seafood, look no further. Nick's Ristorante on Bailey Cove Road, south of Weatherly in Huntsville, is the place for you. Go by and see our buddy Nick and all the family there waiting to serve you with the best food that Huntsville has seen in years and years at Nick's Ristorante on Bailey Cove Road, just south of Weatherly.
Maddie, what are you doing? How do you like the new sign? Sutton and Daughters Furniture? Does Daddy know about this? Well, we can't call it Sutton and Son because we don't have any brothers. And besides, we've helped Daddy in the store practically since we were babies. Sutton and Daughters, that has a nice ring to it. Finally, some respect around here. Laren, this could be the start of a new trend. Either that or World War III.
The brands you trust, like Flexsteel, Hooker, and Lexington, at a price you'll love.
That's because Daddy said sell it.
Sutton Furniture.
Highway 72 in Athens.
If you have been arrested for DUI, plead not guilty and call us. You have the right to a lawyer. If they take your driver's license, call us. We can get it back. I'm attorney Russell Crumbly. Get answers to your legal questions now by calling 855-256-LAWS. The Tennessee Valley Law Call Program is a free service for you and can help you with answers to your legal questions. Call 855-256-LAWS now.
Powered by Crumbly Law Firm and WBHP.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by the Foundation for a Better Life.
Getting on the road in Hazel Green, heading down through Meridianville. It's a little crowded in spots, but right now no wrecks or stalls. We're spotting slow traffic on 565, starting back at I-65 for you folks heading in toward the Arsenal. There's volume there. No problems on Highway 72 through the Athens area. No problems around Decatur. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardee's Traffic Center.
While many rose up with violence, he sat down for peace. Mahatma Gandhi reached out with the strength he cultivated within his soul. So, pass it on from the Foundation for a Better Life at values.com.
WBHP is available everywhere you want to listen on our free iHeartRadio app. Download it now.
I'm Kerry Rosenblum with Rosenblum Realty, and it's football season again, and that means I'll be giving away $50 cash to one lucky Toni and Gary listener each week.
The Toni and Gary SEC Football Pick'em Contest. Find out more online at TonyandGary.com and listen weekdays 5 to 8 a.m. here on 800 WBHP.
Welcome back to the morning show. Okay, what are we giving away?
$40 for Popeye's Cajun Fried Chicken. Movie passes for two at Hollywood 18. Family four-pack to the Botanical Gardens. $20 from Dunkin' Donuts, Huntsville and Madison. And today is Big Prize Giveaway Thursday, so we've added $100 to Nick's Ristorante on South Bailey Cove in Huntsville.
And a day pass to the range at Last Resort Guns, County Line Road in Madison.
All you have to do is call us. At the end of the show, we'll draw from all the people who have called in. And that person wins.
534-3521 and 309-2313.
And we've added more prizes. We have golf for two at Point Mallard's Championship Course and family four-pack to Tate Farms. They'll be open in a couple of weeks. Always a great time up there.
I have a friend that works for State Farm, and he was saying something about where he worked, and the little girl said, his granddaughter said, I've been to Tate Farm. So every time you say Tate Farm, now, well, I think it's State Farm.
You know, all of the schools just about now go on field trips.
Oh, yeah.
There. It's so much fun.
It is fun.
All right. So our trivia is two words. First word begins with B, like in boy. Second word begins with R, like in run. We'll, for example, earlier we had an NFL team that was Baltimore Ravens. We had Clyde Barrow, Bonnie Parker, and Willie Sutton, that was bank robbers. So you see how we play. A digital optical disk data storage format. BR. Or, let me see, what else do we have here? Also known as a squared circle. A squared circle.
Mm-hmm.
BR. Judy Garland and Elton John sang about a yellow one. Some of these are a little easier than others. A type of whole grain. Let's see here. Actor that was married to Judy Carne and Lonnie Anderson. That may take you back a little ways. Lonnie Anderson.
Oh, I got that one.
Right away?
Yeah. I'm still having trouble with the other one? The digital whatever.
Yeah.
Did y'all say where Mia Farrow's son died yesterday?
Oh, no.
Yeah. The one that was on MSNBC?
No.
Oh,
no.
Okay.
This was an adopted son of hers, but
okay.
27.
Wow.
Yeah,
very sad.
Had some sort of car accident. That's all we know.
One of those, huh?
Yep.
His 714 career home runs was the most before Hank Aaron, BR, and one more, a candy bar made of peanuts, caramel, and chocolate-flavored nougat covered in chocolate. What is it? BR. All right, let's go to Jeff. Hey, Jeff.
Here we go again. Wake up.
That is too funny.
Oh, good morning, friends. How's it going?
That is I can't believe Philip was really asleep. We thought he was.
I thought he was faking it.
I didn't know he was setting up.
I thought it was.
Because we kept saying, Philip. And he'd go, I can't snore. But
oh, that was great. Well, hey, my booster rocket is gone, and especially my ice cream. But I'll take a little Blu-ray.
Blu-ray, that's what it is.
Of course.
A digital optical disc data storage format would be Blu-ray. Good job,
Jeff. Do you want me to bring you a candy bar, too, or just I need to be quiet about that?
Yeah, be quiet about the candy bar.
If you were here, you'd get kicked on the shin.
Yes.
For saying Blu-ray?
No, answering more than one question.
Oh, correct. Yeah, no, I don't want to be on the blacklist.
There you go. Good job, Jeff.
All right, thanks. Y'all have a great day.
You too. And Shirley?
Hi, good morning.
Hey, Shirley, how are you?
We're doing great this morning. Beautiful morning out here.
It is nice out there and a little cooler, too.
I don't think I would have gotten that trivia question.
Yeah, I wouldn't have gotten that Blu-ray thing either.
That was a little over my head there.
Well, you are in there, okay?
Thank you so much. You guys have a great weekend.
You too. And Donald. Hey, Donald.
Good morning. How's everybody doing this beautiful morning here?
Good. Thank you.
How about Burt Reynolds?
Burt Reynolds.
There you go, Donald.
He was the one who was married to Lonnie Anderson, and before that, Judy Carne. Do you know who Judy Carne
is? Yeah, I watched a lot of... No, I don't.
And neither do I.
She was on... she was the funny one of the funny girls
either.
On... Oh, what was that? Hee Haw took its place.
I barely remember Hee Haw. I don't know what was before that.
Controversial. Blah, blah. Anyway, I'm going to have to look it up now.
Laughing?
Laughing. Okay. Thank you.
Yay.
She was on Laughing.
That was way before my time. I don't know. Mine too.
But they sell that. Right now they have the best of Hee Haw on one of those, the best of Laughing on one of those Time Life.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times I'll fall asleep to those Time Life
commercials. Because they're so long.
Because they're long and it's a droning, kind of. And I remember seeing what her
She just died a year ago.
Is she? Oh, really?
September of last year.
Wow.
Yeah. Judy Carne.
Who died?
Judy Carne.
Oh. Okay. Now, Lonnie Anderson's still living, right?
Yes.
Once married? Okay.
Yes, she's still alive.
I thought she was.
All right, Donald.
Yeah. All right. Hey, y'all have a wonderful day.
You too.
Tony?
Hey, Tim. Hey, Tim, yeah.
Here's you what? A trivia question.
Trivia question. Okay.
What's Judy Carne's real name?
That's not her real name?
Nope.
I told you, I only know her from Time Life, so I don't know.
Her real name is Joyce Audrey Botteril, Botteril.
Well, you know what happened? Back in those days, mm-hmm. they all changed your names.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't do that now. Now, if they have a weird name, it's exotic.
Mm-hmm.
So they don't have to worry about it.
The first radio gig I had, the guy I worked with, his name was Steve Stringer. But he was telling me that his radio name back in the 70s and 80s and 70s and 80s was Steve King. And I said, I don't understand why. I mean, what's up with changing the name? And he said, well, back when you could look in the phone book and look up Steve Stringer in the phone book, you'd get a lot of crazies making a phone call if you used your real name.
Oh.
So that's why they would use different names.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If you say so.
Well, my name's not in the phone book, so I use Corey Moss.
If you want to call him, just
no one
look
has
it up.
A phone book, Corey Moss.
Hey, Tim,
no,
how
don't.
Are you? Tim?
Hey, guys, good morning. How are you doing today?
Good. How are you, Tim?
I'm doing great. I'm just at work and just been prowling around with the computer and all that. But did somebody get Baby Ruth?
Baby Ruth, that is the candy bar we're looking for. Very good.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite, plus the Snickers, of course, and all that. But, I heard you guys talking yesterday, and we were talking about that government waste and all that. And there's a lot of that goes on in the state, too. I work for a state entity, and it's just unbelievable, the money that's wasted. It is crazy.
And it's not their money, so they don't care, is what it looks like to me.
I know, and the way they act like it's just endless. They act like they're kids and stuff, I think it grows on trees, and they just go out there and pull whatever they want off of it, and just spend it however they want. There's no accountability. So.
There is no accountability.
Yeah, if you've ever been a business owner, you get that.
Yes.
How much you can save by paying attention.
Yeah, but that's your money.
Yeah.
They don't care when it's not their money.
Exactly right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, listen, you guys have a good day.
Thank you,
Thanks
Tim.
A lot.
Okay. And Marilyn. Hey, Marilyn.
Hi, good morning, guys. Hi, Mary.
Hey, good morning.
One of the things that we hear a lot in the government is the use or lose dollars. So if you don't use it, you lose it.
Oh,
that
exactly.
means you don't get it the next year either, when you might really need it. So you don't get rewarded for saving money.
Right.
Oh,
right.
That's true. Right. That's very true.
Yep.
You're absolutely right.
Right. I think if I saved you $1 billion, then you should add maybe $1 million to my budget. So, that doesn't happen.
Doesn't happen.
All right, guys.
Thank you.
Bye.
And Wayne. Hey, Wayne.
Hey, good morning.
Hey.
Was your home run hitter Babe Ruth?
It was Babe Ruth. That's who it is. Good job.
All right, and I don't want to try to answer more than one, because instead of being on the blacklist this morning, it would be considered for BR being black roster.
The black roster, that's right. You don't want on that list.
Thank you, you in the back room.
You know, we played for you this morning, just so you know, as we go into the rest of the day of what was going on in North Carolina, that the family had said that, you know, the man was shot sitting in his car reading a book. We played for you the police chief. If you want to listen to the podcast, go back to the 5 o'clock hour, 6 o'clock hour. The police chief there said, no, we have videotape of him having a gun, getting out of his vehicle. And thus the protests and the looting last night, the criminals that should have been arrested last night, but the police were overwhelmed and brought in the National Guard.
Those clips are on the blog at TonyandGary.com.
If you want to see them yourself, state of emergency declared, and the looting and it's horrible what they've done to downtown Charlotte.
Mm.
So anyway, we'll keep abreast of that, as well as all the other stories, including this little girl. Arizona mom calls the cops to report that her 3-year-old daughter had unbuckled her seatbelt on the drive home. Now, the cops came over and they talked to the little girl about the importance of using a seatbelt. What has happened to parenting?
No kidding.
You call the police on your 3-year-old because she will not keep her seatbelt on in the back seat.
Wow.
Now,
I was just way too mean a mom, I think.
Well, you know, I mean,
convinced.
Well, calling the cops is pretty mean.
Who would not have just spanked their kid and said, put your seatbelt on, like I told you?
Yeah.
But
do you know what I would have done to my kids?
What?
I would have given them the look, and they would have turned around and put their seatbelt on.
The look.
The look.
That's all it takes. When it comes to something like that, just a look is all it takes for me.
I'm just amazed at what has happened to parenting.
Well, the reason she had to do that is because I know she does, and hopefully my wife's not listening, she does exactly what my wife does. She threatens, this parent probably threatens, and never follows through, so the child has no reason to do what you say.
Well, and then when you finally do follow through on something, they think that you've lost your mind.
Well, yeah, and you're abusing them.
And you're abusing them, yes.
Well, mm-hmm. I have worked very hard to always follow through with what I say for that very reason. That's why the look works now.
Really? Mm-hmm. Show me the look. Oh. You can uncross your eyes now, Corey. That's fine. All right, we'll take
that. Was my Hillary Clinton impression. You know, the crossed eyes.
We will take a break. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
On your smartphone, download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And listen on your computer free anywhere in the world.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2. And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Toni and Gary.
It's the morning show with Toni and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
From the Tennessee Valley to your radio, it's WBHP's Valley Happenings.
Hi, I'm Leslie Ware, owner of Exhale Day Spa and Fashion Heist Clothing, right here in Huntsville, Alabama. On October 24th, I, along with 7 other stars, will be stepping into my dancing shoes and stepping way outside of my comfort zone to compete in the 2016 Stars Dancing for Heels event. Heels provides free medical and dental care to children in need at our Huntsville and Madison County schools. You can help support this amazing cause and watch the event live by visiting heelsinc.org. Go online today and vote for me, Leslie Ware.
And that's what's happening. For more information on Valley Happenings, log on to WBHPAM.com, keyword events. The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is brought to you by the Foundation for a Better Life.
It's crowded on University right now, but so far no wrecks or stalls. We're not spotting any big problems around Athens. It's crowded around Decatur as well. We're spotting some slow-and-go traffic on 565 heading eastbound from I-65 past the airport and toward the Arsenal. No big problems on the parkway, but we are spotting some slow-and-go traffic on 431 around Big Cove and Governor's Drive, as a lot of folks are heading into work this morning. I'm Captain Carl in the Hardy's Traffic Center.
While many rose up with violence, he sat down for peace. Mahatma Gandhi reached out with the strength he cultivated within his soul. So, pass it on from the Foundation for a Better Life at values.com.
Hiring people is probably the worst part of my job. It's such a hassle, the searching, the sorting through resumes. Most people don't have the right experience.
We started using ZipRecruiter about 3 months ago. Right from the start, you could tell it was going to make hiring a lot easier. One click and my job was posted to 100+ job boards, all the top sites.
All of the candidates came to my dashboard, and it's easy to compare them. Thumbs up if I liked them, thumbs down if I didn't. No emails and attachments, printing up docs, none of that.
And I couldn't believe the number of great applicants we got. I had the person we needed within 1 week. I don't know how we hired before ZipRecruiter.
Whether you're looking to fill one position or 20, find the best candidates with ZipRecruiter, where your job is just one click away from 100+ job sites. ZipRecruiter, the fastest way to hire. And right now you can try ZipRecruiter free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/talkradio. That's ZipRecruiter.com/talkradio. ZipRecruiter.com/talkradio.
Hey, it's Bill Cunningham, the Great American. Join me live on Sunday night beginning at 9. Now back to Toni and Gary in the morning on WBHP.
I'm Stuart Tankson with Pro Fence of the Tennessee Valley. Add value, beauty, and security with a new fence for your home or business. Call us at 256-584-0092 or visit us on the web at profencellc.com.
We love Stuart Tanksley, Pro Fence. I'm looking at a video right now, horrible video, of a white man in a parking garage in Charlotte begging for his life as he's being beaten by at least a six, eight, maybe a dozen thugs.
Protesters?
Yeah.
Wow.
Being beaten, begging for his life as he's on the ground being beaten.
Who did he shoot?
He was just in the parking garage.
Uh-huh.
Now, this has got to stop. I can see these people. And if I can see them, the police can see them. Somebody needs to be arrested. There needs to be consequences for this stuff. Anyway, mm-hmm. It's crazy. All right, bid on Huntsville.
It's going on right now.
You can bid on different great prices, like a motorhome.
Like from Bankston Motorhomes.
From Bankston Motorhomes.
You can get floor coverings from Floor Coverings International.
How do you get there?
Go to TonyandGary.com.
There's a significant difference between being slightly out of tune or perfectly in tune. If your financial plan is even slightly out of tune, you may be paying too much for taxes, exposing yourself to too much risk, or retiring without a sound income plan. Is your financial plan out of tune? Listen to WBHP The Big Talker, Saturdays at 10 a.m. to Financially Tuned with Don Cloud of Cloud Financial to get your financial future in tune.
At iHeartMedia, we've harnessed the power of sound in a way that can help you expand your reach to a new group of target customers and grow your business through customized and effective advertising. Call 844-BUY-RADIO or go to iHeartMedia.com.
Sean Hannity.
Boston Globe is now calling on all sane Republicans to abandon Donald Trump before it's too late. I don't think so.
Weekdays 2 to 5 p.m. on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
It's time to think real estate, buying, selling, or renting. Carrie Rosenblum with Rosenblum Realty, representing 55 years of experience, says that the rental business in the Tennessee Valley is a very important factor.
It is. We provide a service of finding a rental home for a family or individual in the Tennessee Valley. We've got a good selection. And homes can include condominiums and also townhomes, any number of single-family dwellings in the area. We have a good selection. And what we encourage people to do to go to our website at rosenblumrealty.com, click the rental button, they can find the one that fits their budget. It's a great option for people that come to town brand new, trying to learn the area before they buy, or maybe someone just that's the best fit for them. Come see us at Rosenblum Realty. We'll find the rental you need.
And they find you by calling?
256-539-9501.
Or they'll find you on the web?
At rosenblumrealty.com.
It's Rosenblum Realty. Carrie Rosenblum, the man to talk to from Rosenblum Realty.
This is 800 and 1230 WBHP, the Valley's Big Talker.
Are you ready?
Here we go.
Congratulations to Tim Springer. Hey, a lot of prizes, that's for sure. All right, bid on Huntsville. If you go to our blog at TonyandGary.com, right under the football stuff, mm-hmm. Save big, bid on Huntsville is back. It says click here to shop, and you can see all the different things that you can bid on.
Mallard golf passes.
And this is big.
It is huge.
Yeah.
Buddy's small engine.
Mm-hmm.
Bankston Motorhomes.
floor coverings international
and a lot of other
and a
things.
Whole bunch of other stuff.
So click here, you can save up to 50% off retail. Go to our blog, tonyandgary.com. Mary, thank you so much as always for being with us.
I always enjoy it. Thank you for having
me.
I
said I wish you could come in every day.
Kind of early.
Yeah. What's your cell number?
256-755-1008.
Mary's helping people all over the Tennessee Valley. So
all day, every
her.
Day.
Yeah. But any mortgage, anything to do with your home. You guys have a great day.
Sunny today, 92. Bye, y'all.
Glenn Beck follows Fox News on WBHP Huntsville, WHOS Decatur, and WDRM FM HD2 Decatur, an iHeart radio station.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu in Charlotte, North Carolina. Police trying to break up a second night of protests. Demonstrators.